I think tight on just Ronan, Titus is fine. Because we got everybody else.
Right, we're live with all that audio.
Oh, I'm off.
I have audio coming through somewhere.
Oh, TJ.
Hot.
Yo, DJ, pull that up. It's the act. It's the act. Yes, time to talk shop for you. Yankees love is the act. Hello, Roback.com, Roback.com, promo code YAK.
Q-Zip.
Polos, hoodies, joggers, shorts, 20% off your first purchase. We had a hot mic. Hopefully, we didn't say anything so stupid. Way to go, Stefan. Way to fucking just...
Put us out there.
It's Stefan's fault I got caught saying that slur.
Stefan. Hello,
that
boys.
Piece of shit.
Day three.
Mm-hmm.
I'm ready to tap out.
Ready to go?
I'm tired.
Yep.
But we're here day three. Ready to put on a good show. Hank's show last night was incredible.
What'd you do afterwards that has you so tired?
We had to finish the show.
Ah.
And then I didn't fall asleep till like midnight, and then I set my alarm for 7:30 and I woke up at 5.
Drats.
Brutal.
Drats.
Brutal. But we're here. We're gonna have fun. Yeah, that's all I got.
The show was great last night, and then afterwards, Hank put on a fucking show on the casino floor following the lead of Stephen Che.
He was bombed.
Hank?
Yeah.
Yo, at the
hammered.
Show.
That's a funny choice of words.
Oh, yeah. Well, I noticed, though, that his two writers weren't in the room.
Yeah. I don't want to be credited as writer.
Wait,
now.
Titus and
who's his writer?
Brandon wrote for him?
Yes.
Nick, KB, you guys weren't there.
I was going to go.
And?
I don't want to say, but I will. I was walking to Walgreens to get some big bottled waters, and I fell down about 10 steps outside. And I thought I broke my ulna.
What?
Yeah, and it's really, really sore.
Your ulna's sore.
My hat fell off. It was on the second step. I was on the bottom in a puddle. Crossing the street.
Did anyone witness it?
One guy at the bottom, and he said, dude.
Oh,
but
no.
But like now, like it hurts really fucking bad to make like a fist.
Wait, is it your funny bone?
No.
It's right by his radius.
It's like I have this red line going down like where my bone is.
It's a hairline fracture, brother.
Is it actually?
No, I don't know. Sounded good though.
Real, like you can feel like it. Feel that, Brandon. I feel
squeeze
like shut out. And I broke.
I can see it from
Okay, that's bad.
And so I didn't.
Brandon?
And I didn't go to Hank's.
Where did you jump?
Because I was waiting to see if I should go to the hospital.
I
fucking fell down the steps. Steps are the worst thing to fall down. It's all corner.
Okay, that's a
almost
good,
the only thing to fall down.
Yeah, that's a good excuse, Kyle.
I paid to watch.
Oh,
you were. I had a date night. Yeah.
Well, let's see the receipt then.
I should have went, and I deserved it.
No, but let's see the receipt. Since you paid to watch.
You could have just come and left in the first 5 minutes like Dave did.
Yeah.
Memes literally ran Dave out of the show.
Yeah, I watched.
Yeah.
So memes got me to turn it off. I turned it off.
He was so bad. I told memes afterwards, like, as bad as he thinks it went, just know that it was way worse.
I was right.
What?
Are you disappointed in him?
No, I'm not disappointed. He's not a public speaker. He was like, there's nothing I could do to make that.
Well, he put no effort.
He did put no effort, so that's why I feel okay, like, roasting him, because it wasn't like.
Can we show clips?
Like, if Hank did well. Hank had a couple moments that got a little iffy, but like he finished really strong, told some great stories.
He had a good lizard bit.
The three people he hates in New York, Barstool, New York was very funny. But he, and also the dead goldfish story. Yeah. So I didn't even know that story. That was Hank, for people who don't know, we had a gambling goldfish named Larry, and he has a tattoo of
he
Larry.
He said some of the crowd didn't even know that.
Yeah.
He said only like three people clapped for Larry.
So the crowd in Chicago and night and day.
Night and day.
The momentum was so much stronger in Chicago.
Well,
they were excited for him.
It didn't help too that Hank started the show saying, "Anyone here live in Vegas?" And everyone's like, "Yeah." And he's like, "What the fuck? Are you prostitutes or gamblers?"
Yeah, like.
And like that was it.
Yeah.
It wasn't like there wasn't a punchline. He just berated them, and then for the rest of the show, he's like, "Why don't you guys give me anything?" But he has a tattoo, so Larry, our gambling goldfish, who finished 60% in the NFL in 2017, Hank got a tattoo of him on his leg. When the tattoo artist said, "I need to like draw Larry, do you have a point of reference?" Hank didn't say like, "Oh, here's a cartoon of Larry, here's just a picture of a goldfish." He got Larry the dead carcass of our fish that was in the freezer at the Barstool headquarters and showed him that. So he has like a like mangled dead goldfish.
With like a black eye, like a black moldy eye.
I always thought the tattoo was horrendous. I never knew that's why.
That's a fun little tidbit. Hank could have Googled the word goldfish.
We literally had a cartoon of Larry.
He could have just did the cracker. Footage and photography. Yeah.
Could have done his outline.
Anything.
Was he panicked?
I don't know, but that was a very funny story because I'd never heard it, and he had. I assume that was maybe a couple of your punchlines.
The tags.
You wouldn't get JFK's blown brains out.
Nah, that doesn't sound like a joke I'd make.
But Hank crushed. I thought he did really well given the circumstances. It was a fun night.
Was it Meme's fault?
So Meme's also said that he crushed in the preset, and he had a
What's
joke.
What's the preset?
The pre-show. He did a dry run.
With no audience?
No audience.
So he crushed.
You guys made it seem like Memes would do great. Like,
in the run.
He's a funny guy.
Yeah, you talked like Memes is obviously going to.
He was the least.
But he didn't try to be funny. He's a funny guy. He just got into reading a transcript.
Correct.
Without prefacing, like, "Hey, this is a transcript of a lost episode."
He also read a transcript of Monday's show.
Right.
That was very confusing.
So I was like, "What? What is going on?" Yeah, I didn't know what he was doing.
But I think he got a joke cut, which there was someone who cut the joke from Barstool, which I don't think they should be cutting jokes. But I don't, TJ, I sent you the image. He was going to put this up, Flight Risk.
Wait, that got cut?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Why?
What's the point of
the minute I thought it got cut, I was like, "I'm going to put this up on the Yak tomorrow."
Yeah.
That's fine.
So someone cut that, which they shouldn't be cutting jokes on a comedy show.
On a pay-per-view.
On a pay-per-view comedy show. That's Max as Osama bin Laden and also Max.
That joke would have bombed too.
Flight Risk. But Memes, he said that the minute he felt nervous, he was going to play tequila, and he did it like 30 seconds in.
Oh. Uh-oh.
Yeah. So, but it was a good night. It was a fun night.
And that's a true punishment.
Like, yeah.
That's a good.
Everybody. That's a good punishment. Yes. Yeah. And we told the origin story of pardon my take, that you have to buy the pay-per-view to find. Wow. I might have basically entrapped PFT into being Barstool for life via drug use.
Mm-hmm. Ah.
Yeah.
You have a photo of him doing drugs?
I was just stuffing cocaine up his nose in Arizona.
Yeah. Barstool Pat, formerly gay, still gay, but dropped the gay from the name, has an album of every coworker doing blow. Just in case they like
snaps the quickest.
He showed it to me. He just swiped through. It's unbelievable. Every one of us. He's a real monster. Not just because he's gay.
But it was a good night. It was a good night. And yeah, Dave scurried out. Like it was all bang bang. It was Dave left, and then 2 seconds later, Hank was like, "Shout out my boss, Dave Portnoy. Love him."
Oh, that clip's online.
That's
so funny. That's unbelievable comedic timing.
Yeah, Dave. Look at Dave's face. He was in hell.
He couldn't even pretend to give like a sympathy laugh.
Yeah. Well, because it was the perfect thing for Dave. Like, Dave has always been like hands off with Pardon My Take. He's like, I don't know what these guys do, but they're popular. And so then coming to this show with no context, he was like, why, what is going on right now? He was in hell.
Whose content do you think he like gets and likes at Barstool?
Pizza reviews?
Yeah, probably pizza or day trader.
Day trader.
He likes Jerry stuff.
Yeah, he Frank.
You think he watches Frank. Jerry after? Yeah, Frank.
Frank was very rude. Frank had a very rude moment.
What did he do?
During Memes' set, he played cricket sounds from his phone. Very loud.
Frank,
very loud. I had to turn to him.
You just scold him. Yeah, he said, Frank, stop. But it was so loud that you sang Frank Stop that it brought...
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
It was so
It was very loud when he was playing cricket noises. So it was a good night. It was a fun, it was a true punishment. That was as brutal of a punishment as you could possibly have.
I'm glad I just fell down 15 steps in front of the Gucci store.
That was your problem.
That was probably on someone's like prank video too. Like, you know how the people do like... Vegas. Danny Jackal was probably doing
She probably
like Stairway in Vegas prank videos are a whole.
And then
genre.
She was at the bottom of the steps, and she was just like,
"What was the address?" Because grab, there are
Bush or shaved.
Bush or shaved. Hey, you're cute. Just kidding. There's a camera over there.
There are cameras everywhere in Vegas. What? Where was the address of this?
Oh yeah, you think we can find it?
I don't know.
I was on the phone with my mom when it, happened, and I hung up when I got to the bottom of the steps. And she thought I got hit by a car. She called me, like, she texted me, and I was, like, just walking back, all soaking wet. And, it was bad. She said I yelled.
Oh, man.
Yeah, fun
That's
night.
That's a good excuse.
Thanks, man.
How was the hockey game, Brandon? You seem tired.
It was very good. I did stay up a little bit too late. It was just very loud. That arena was just a whole, like, concert kind of feel. Like, a lot of laser lights, a lot of theatrics, a lot of...
The goal horn is crazy outside.
Crazy.
Yeah,
you can hear it. We were
in
our room. Yeah, that's the goal horn. That's when they
score. Tugboat.
Oh, you left early?
We left with about 10 minutes to go in the third period.
There's so many Canadians at the hotel.
So many. Yeah. There were so many Oilers fans.
Yeah.
There were probably 8,000 Oilers fans there yesterday.
They're just they have such a great demeanor.
Yeah.
I was with some Oilers fans in like at 10 o'clock going down the elevator. It's like, let's go win a couple K. I was like, that's not how it works.
Mm-mm.
I shared.
They were feeling it.
I shared an elevator with Seth Rollins.
I did too.
Oh.
I was first.
Nah.
I told you. I text you, and then you. I have the text.
And you went elevator hunting?
Yeah.
Seth Rollins was staying at the hotel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, well, tough times for WWE.
Yeah. Well, they stayed at that hotel last time. I remember. I had to come here to do interviews.
I was on the elevator. I heard Nick, and I looked up. The voice sounded familiar. It was fucking Seth.
Oh.
And, well, that's. I feel like now you're doing tricks on it, little bro. That didn't happen. You didn't say.
No, he's probably a fan of wrestling.
He liked
wrestling content.
Yeah, he liked that, and he liked Fantasy Football Factory with Ronan.
Yeah,
Ronan and Hank.
Yeah, a great show.
Incredible. Did you talk to him?
Yeah.
What'd you say?
I was like, "Hey, Seth, big fan, probably biggest of Barstool."
Nailed it.
Yeah, a lot of Edmonton folk in the. What's Edmonton like, KB?
Probably depressing.
It's gotta be dreary.
Reminded me of Pittsburgh when I visited.
Really? That's probably, yeah.
Oh, I've never
got Pittsburgh
there.
Vibes.
It's pretty far up, too, into Canada.
Yeah.
They used to have Eskimos, now they got Elks.
Yeah.
Is Eskimo a slur?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Brandon, hot mic, bro.
Ronan, did I tell you about the most awkward exchange probably more awkward than Memes' set yesterday? We went and interviewed Kittle at the 49ers Hotel. And so we were walking out with Kittle, and Dre Greenlaw walked by, and Kittle was like, "What's up, Dre?" And I just turned around, I was like, "Shouldn't have gone after Big Dom." And he just looked at me, he's like, "What the fuck?" And he just kept on walking.
Oh, wow.
It did not land.
Damn.
Yeah
they
it
hate the Eagles.
It did not land.
I think they're not even ready to joke about the Eagles.
I felt so shitty saying that. It's so like, funny. I'm not even a Philly fan. I just like... Oh, yeah, Big Dom, Dre Greenlaw.
You just love security guards.
Yeah, you're a fan of security.
It fell so flat. He just gave me a shake of a head, like, I want to beat this guy's ass.
Explain that real quick. What is who is Dre Greenlaw?
He's a linebacker for the Niners, really, really good player. He's the one who got in the tussle with Big Dom when he got kicked out and Dom got kicked out. And
he
he's
didn't like
in his
that.
Own hotel.
He could have taken a joke. Yeah.
But I'm, like, walking by. He doesn't know me.
Right.
And I just said it, like, as we were crossing paths. It was basically like an asshole fan chirp inside the team hotel.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it didn't work.
That's a safe space.
Yeah.
He's supposed to be at home base.
I violated that.
Fuck him.
Yeah. Shouldn't have gone after Big Dom.
He shouldn't have.
Shouldn't have.
Big Dom got suspended for like this season because of that.
Yeah.
And that's because he went after Big Dom.
Yeah.
The security guard was
Big Dom
security.
Shouldn't have been right there. The
security guard shouldn't have been right next to the coach. Oh, like every security guard is.
All securing?
All our coaches now need security right
there. Every coach has a guy. Do they not? Am I lying, Steven? Yeah,
they do. Within, on the sideline for sure.
Yes. Yeah.
Two other guys.
I don't know them by security name. Security guys? Like, also, if this doesn't happen,
Mike?
We don't know Big Dom.
Big Cat's uncle. Big Cat's.
Bobby Lang.
Yeah, Bobby Lang.
Bobby Lang. St. Joe's.
Y'all just saying names. You're just saying names.
Two other NFL.
Right.
Yeah, Bobby Lang is
my stepfather.
Do you remember the coaches? Do you remember the beef between Harbaugh and Jim Schwartz?
Yeah.
Where you got?
No.
You guys are being haters. Big Dom did get to keep practicing during the week. He coached during the week.
Yeah, that's all you need.
By the way, that laugh you heard is Stephen Che. He's here.
Oh yeah, Che.
How was vacation, Che?
It was fun. 2.5 days. Very long. It was fun. It was
sightseeing.
A good group of guys. Yeah, we did some sightseeing. Not as much as we hoped. Four Corners closed 20 minutes before we got there. And that was a whole ordeal, but it was fun. Yesterday, we stayed overnight like in the Grand Canyon National Park.
Okay.
We got to the park at like 9. If we got there like 40 minutes later, there would be zero visibility. Like it started snowing and you couldn't see anything. Thank you.
You got really wet. And you became un-Asian.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
We did say that about you.
What do you mean?
Like when you get wet, you turn white.
Yeah.
You lost your Asianness.
Well, that's fair. I was probably.
No, it's not. It's not really.
It's the least fair thing he's ever said.
Was I wearing a hood?
I think so.
Yeah, okay, so then, you can't see the black hair, which is the
part. Kyle has black
calling
hair.
Card of
what's
Asian.
Your telltale Asian sign?
Yeah, what does make you Asian?
Yeah, look at that.
I never thought about it.
You're just a nerd.
Yeah, my black hair is covered.
Oh, is that what it
see
was?
Your black hair.
I see. Yeah, you have strands right there.
A little bit.
You never have strands. That's the first time we've ever seen strands.
Yeah, I guess that's true. It gets all damp and down. I usually flop it up.
You sound like you've been through war.
Me and Jeff D. Lowe were on the tables last night till like 1:30.
Oh, so this wasn't because of the trip. It was because of
No. Dude, I had a great time. We were just doing immaculate grids for hours. It was fun.
You fucking them up?
I fucked up two the first day and it was bad, but we got over it. Doing Immaculate Grid with Frank is actually hilarious because he'll say, you know, whatever, Bills 49ers, and he'll source options and then he'll give it 5 minutes and then he'll just name a player from the 70s he's going to do and he just puts it in. No, nobody's signing off on it. But it's a good time. He will, though, if it's your team, so if it's like the Knicks or the Bucks or something like that, he will take your answer. And if you're wrong, it's lights out.
Yeah.
Like Mikey Betts got like two Bears wrong in a row and he like lost it.
What's the relationship between, because I've only seen it a little bit, but it feels like Mikey Betts gets the brunt of Frank's anger and then Jenks calms him down.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes. Jenks doesn't really get, if Jenks gets yelled at, he like guilts Frank about it later and then Frank apologizes. And Frank is almost always in the wrong for that.
Yeah.
So Jenks is correct to do that. But then, Mikey Betts, he gets the...
He gets like screamed at by Frank.
Does Frank ever hit him?
Not that I've seen.
Mikey, come here.
But that like screenshot of Frank turning around, I saw that face several times on the trip.
But Mikey laughs it off though.
Yeah, Mikey
he can handle it.
Well, Frank,
it bothers Jenks.
Will Frank demean Betts' self-worth? Like you truly dig at him. Like say you're worthless, like you bring no value to this career.
No.
You have a life because of
me. He's not like that.
I made you, bitch.
But like he's very clearly running the show. Like we stopped at the first gas station. I was like, all right, what time are we going to get lunch? They're like, I don't know. We got whatever Frank wants. And I was like, all right. So I was like, are we going to stop in a couple hours? Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know if Frank wants to. So it's like, we very much didn't have a plan. Like, I actually didn't eat yesterday.
It was
just like, well, they went to the hot dog place and I was like, all right, I had so many hot dogs the past few days, so I didn't want that. And Jenks only eats Cliff Bars.
What?
He's like allergic to butter. or like any dairy.
And he
product.
Hates cheese. He's like he can't be around cheese.
I saw him eat at least 25 Cliff Bars.
I asked him for diet advice once, and he says I'm not the guy to ask.
Yeah.
Wait, I only eat one. He said I only eat two things.
So you didn't eat, and he just ate Cliff Bars, and Frank had a few hot dogs.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Well, you went to that Tex-Mex restaurant on Monday night where you had the nice green chili soup.
Yes. Yeah, that was good.
Isn't the green chili soup what got you sick at the Chuck E.
Cheese? Oh, David Buster's. Yeah, you're right. This place was not
his brother's birthday.
Place. Yeah. This place was like a, it was like on a reservation. You say that right?
Yeah, you can say
that. No.
Sure.
Yeah, so it was like, you weren't
going to say that. Since your hair's up, you can say
reservation. You can't say reservation.
Say reservation.
I don't know.
I mean, restaurants use those all the time.
Yeah, whatever. So,
actually, let's cancel check.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to make an appointment for 7 o'clock at this steakhouse.
One R word, please.
Reservation is a word for our people. You're not meant to say that word.
Oh, fuck. So what else? Like, did you guys sleep or were you just driving pretty much the whole time?
We drove from Chicago to Texas in one day. So we did a lot of driving. It would be like drive all day pretty much. Our only stops were hot dog stops.
What about what'd you do for gas? Bucky's or like did you align it with the hot dog stop?
For Bucky's was a must. We saw a billboard for Bucky's and Frank, like, I've never heard him talk so positively about something. He was like, this is like the best place on God's green earth. And I've never even heard of Bucky's. And like Wawa or Sheetz and those type of places I've seen. It's like, all right, huge gas station, nice snack selection. Bucky's is like half a mile big. It's got
Bucky's is
buy,
Walmart with gas pumps
and like antiques.
It's way nicer than Walmart. You can get fresh peanut brittle there.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, what the fuck?
Fresh what?
You ever got fresh peanut brittle at Walmart, Nick? You fucking idiot.
Yeah. Well, like they have like a fudge. They're making like fudge there.
Yeah, Walmart doesn't fucking have fudge.
So you took hot dog stops and a Bucky's stop.
Bucky's stop. Grand Canyon, Four Corners.
Just hot dog stops.
No one else even tries to make a suggestion.
Yeah, like if you had said, hey, can we pull over? I'm really hungry or like I need some air. They would have just been like, nah.
They did not make I made a few suggestions. Like I suggested, I was like, hey, can we listen to the Jameis Winston interview on Part of My Take? And he was like, yeah, sure. He's accommodating. And Frank definitely respects me. I got that.
But, he let you listen to a podcast. He really holds you in high standards.
Was Frank sleeping?
Comparatively.
On the car ride?
He didn't sleep at all in the car.
Really?
Yeah. No car sleep. He was in the front seat the whole time.
Love that.
We listened to, we got
he
in the car.
He did not sleep in the car.
What?
He didn't sleep in the car at all?
Nobody slept. Jinx fell asleep the last like 10 minutes of ride.
Frank will fall asleep just sitting at work.
That's old though. Time. I think that was like heavier Frank.
Yeah.
Heavier,
all right, so he's gotten out of that. Okay.
Yeah. He also like, he must feel like it's part of his job to do the Immaculate Grids, because he, I guess, thought he was doing us a favor. He cleared out his cookies. So he did
what?
Fresh.
A tech term, Kyle.
Wait,
I could understand your confusion.
Not.
He cleared his browser history or whatever.
Say that.
Wait, so
cleared his
how does that make it so that it's...
So he, I guess, shares his scores online?
Yeah.
And I guess they save your scores.
Okay.
I don't do them as much, but...
He cleared his cookies for you.
He cleared his cookies, so he's going to do them all with us. So
got
this was like
it.
The group activity for the whole ride.
Got it.
How
many grids are there?
Like hundreds.
There's one every day. Because
he goes back historically and does them.
Oh.
But the other interesting thing was he listens to... I was wondering what the music situation was going to be. And I got on the
Was it Yacht Rock?
So that was a big part of it. But he had like a radio show, or I guess it was a Sirius show that he had downloaded that was from the 70s. It was like a specific date. It was like a countdown of the top 10.
I fucking love doing that, yeah.
Yeah.
I love doing that,
too. We did that for 8 hours.
Yeah, but it's an old one. Yeah.
Was it on this date? Was it,
yeah.
Was it February? And how,
this week in 1978 or something.
Wait, does he have it recorded? Or is it Sirius?
I think it's Sirius, but like we did a bunch of those. But then I also learned, because we, at the end of the night, we were in the car 15 hours, wanted to go to sleep. Frank And I learned this about Rico Bosco from Surviving. He falls asleep to like the Rent soundtrack on his phone, like very loudly, with the lights on. Frank similarly falls asleep with Yacht Rock blaring.
He loves it.
Very loudly. So like it became like, we're not gonna share, like you can't share a room with Frank.
Did you guys share rooms?
We didn't, no.
Oh, I was gonna
when
say.
When you're that close, it's like, and then the Frank.
Yeah. Did he like?
It became clear he could not have a roommate.
Did he ever like giggle or could get real giddy?
Yeah.
What made him?
Cried.
Yeah, that's the opposite.
I don't know what the song.
Oh, joyful cry.
Yeah, a joyful cry. So I guess it was the song.
Oh, that's what that was?
Yeah. It's the 86 Mets, right?
Yeah. Whenever they won, I guess Bob Costas is saying it. They do a vignette, and that song is playing.
And he cried?
He cried. And he said whenever he hears that song, he will cry.
And he
song is it?
I don't. It's a very obscure song. Mikey Betts has.
Yeah, we talked about this clip the other day.
Yeah,
we.
I know, but I need to figure out what song it is so that we can just play it on command.
Desperado or something.
Get him crying.
I think that was the sign. It does.
Yeah.
Like, similar. Like if he hears it, he just.
Oh shit! You guys should come out to that song.
What? Whatever song this is?
Yeah.
To make him cry?
Tearful Frank.
That would throw him off.
That would be a power move.
Yeah. No, I think that would mellow him out.
Yeah, I think that'd put him right where
he wants
to be.
That'd be a better position. Because it's a happy cry. Anger.
And it's like a championship cry.
Yeah. Hmm. So are you happy you lost and had to take this drive?
Yeah, I didn't. It was honestly very fun. And those guys were all good guys. We had a fun experience.
Did any tickling?
What?
Did anyone tickle each other? Like you were like play around, tussle, nuggies.
No.
Appreciate for a question.
Roughhousing.
There was zero tickling. On
wedgie.
There.
Yeah, I don't think I.
Any pranks? Any pranks?
Any hijinks?
I think Mikey Betts threw one of the Immaculate Grids on purpose to get Frank mad.
Oh,
that's funny. Yeah.
Anybody rip ass and not let you roll the window down?
No, I didn't. The car didn't smell. I don't think anyone farted. The
hot dog.
Like, that's not possible.
I drove
28 hours only
perfect
eating
game.
Hot dog stops.
And yeah. Nobody farted?
I farted. It was silent though. It was like
it's a Jerry after dark challenge. Try to drive across the country without farting.
I love that you didn't eat yesterday. They just didn't let you eat.
No, it was just like went to the Grand Canyon. Blizzard, wanted to get out. We stopped at a gas station, so I got snacks and then hit it here. But all the stops are hot dog stops. But it's also very uncomfortable. I can't spoil it, but he didn't like all the hot dog places that we went. So he's in there and just saying how much it sucks. Hot dog places are not big.
No.
So they're maybe the size of this room. So he's talking about how bad the hot dogs are and the cook is right there.
But it's with hot dogs, it's almost not on the cook. It's on the sourcing of the hot dog.
It's the meat.
Yeah, the snap is dependent on the casing of the hot dog.
That would still be the most disheartening day of your life. You're a hot dog cook who
in West Texas.
Yeah. You get no customers and then Frank.
Just a crew rolls in and just roasts your hot dogs, roasts your livelihood. Probably. All right, we're off to Vegas.
All right. I'm not even full.
One of them, I can't say which one. One of them he threw up. He had one bite of each of them and threw them out, and then just proceeded to talk about how bad they were in this restaurant at 9 o'clock p.m.
Oh my god!
15 minutes before closing with a skeleton staff. It was pretty.
That place will be closed in a week.
They did it in Jacksonville, and I think the place did close shortly thereafter.
Wait, what?
He did that when I went to Jacksonville with him. He did that. He spiked the hot dog into the trash in front of the owner.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Because he does it in the restaurant, and I think it's closed.
What a trip. I'm kind of jealous. Not really.
It was fun.
I'm not.
I wish I could snap my fingers and be on it for an hour.
Would you do it again, Steven?
Yeah.
Well, they're not driving back.
No, they're flying back.
Yeah. Okay. All right, I'm going to do a couple ads
because
I got a bunch today. Mango RX. The Yak is sponsored by Mango RX. Mango RX is a premier telehealth platform providing free doctor visits for a seamless healthcare experience 100% online. Explore innovative treatments and unique formulas that redefine how you approach your healthcare. Trust in the expertise of our board-certified physicians when purchasing any of our products. MangoRx combines hard science with innovation, ensuring the highest standards in healthcare solutions. Start your free 100% online consultation today and begin your journey to better health with MangoRx. We're also brought to you by Body Armor. Body Armor is our favorite. We're drinking it right now. Kyle's drinking it right now.
Yep.
We're brought to you by Body Armor Zero Sugar. Body Armor Zero Sugar, you have it right here. This is the fruit punch. Body Armor Zero Sugar's new zero sugar sports drink from our friends at Body Armor with no artificial sweeteners, flavors, or dyes. Whether you've looked or you're looking to stay hydrated or recovering from a long weekend, Body Armor Zero Sugar has got you covered. Go get it right now if you're here in Vegas. If you're ready for maybe Monday morning after football season ends, Body Armor Zero Sugar will get you back to neutral. So Body Armor Zero Sugar has great tasting flavors like fruit punch and lemon lime. Available in stores nationwide, but you can head on over to Body Armor Store on Amazon and get yours today. Keeps you hydrated, no artificial sweeteners. Body Armor Zero Sugar, what are you doing?
I have to have a run test my arm.
Is it bad?
It feels nothing like how my arm feels.
Can I feel it?
There's like a... It hurts to like roll my sleeve up.
Just run your arm down there down, and then run like your arm sideways. Down yours.
There's like a bump right there.
Oh yeah, you're fucked.
Yeah, that's cool.
Oh god.
Cast, I'll sign your cast.
Might be a bone spur.
I don't want to go to a doctor. Vegas hospital. I think I can just ride it out, right?
Yeah.
Let it ride.
What?
A couple days. Usually if you tear something, you let the swelling go down and then you get I mean you don't.
He's just talking about an ACL, right?
Yeah. That's all the
how much money did you win last night?
Oh yeah.
$1,700 maybe.
What?
Whoa.
Yeah. Wow.
Jackie Lowe won like $9,000 last night.
What?
He's a freak.
We started playing craps, did okay there, and then roulette table just like.
It boomed.
Ron was there. Jeff was just calling. We all had our set of numbers, and then it was everyone we worked with, and we all just decided to like heavy up on one person's number at one point. And then TJ was there. TJ hit on his number, I think.
When Hank got there. On three of his first five spins, he hit the number.
What?
Jeff or Hank?
Hank.
How much money did Hank win?
Hank was also like, then he'd be putting like 500 on a number.
Ah.
That's Hank, though.
Yeah, he's goofy.
He was celebrating.
Yeah, was he sniping? Like you putting all your stack on like one number?
Was spreading it out, but like there would be one where it was like very clear that was a stack, and it hit like multiple times.
Was
like
Jerry
eruptions.
There?
Yeah, he was there at the first crew, and then it was a ghost town
number, and then he lost a few, and then like
I max bet on a
those
number.
Guys and it got very behave hard. Like fiends on the table. Mm-hmm. I could never do that.
Jersey Jerry was like. All three nights so far, I've been like, yeah, I got to go work at like 9 o'clock, and his like heart drops. Like, well, you're not going to gamble with me? I'm like, I wish I could, dude. And he like, it feel like I'm letting down like a child. And
I
get so upset.
I haven't seen him in a couple of days, so I've been like concerned.
He is like, he has like an unruly student teacher relationship with like the what is it, the pit?
Yeah, with the
He won't stop vaping. It's smoke free.
And he says their name all the time.
He accuses the dealers of not shuffling right.
Or he'll like ask like, "Is this machine like why is it not see through if it's like really shuffling like that?"
I think Jerry might have an addictive personality.
That is the most. But he's also building a crew of his own.
Oh yeah,
he was flanked by
Lucas and Ryan.
Lucas and Ryan, he'll like beckon them the same way that. Frank will. I think it's kind of the dream to have a beckonable crew.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I don't have any.
He was with the dude.
You do. Yeah. They're on the program.
No, but I don't beckon you guys. I guess Che.
Yeah.
Che is definitely a beckon guy.
Yeah. And you'll rent him out. You'll put him on loan like a soccer club to Frank's crew.
Yeah, that's true.
Is Mook our beckon guy?
We don't beckon Mook.
I mean, Che has a job for me that's just strictly the job requirement is to annoy me.
Yeah.
Because there's no one who can annoy me.
I did that today.
Like Che.
You annoyed him today?
Yeah, no, he annoyed me today.
What did he do?
He just reminded me of shit I have to do. But he's the perfect person for it because I hate every time he annoys me, but he never takes it personally. Like if I had anyone else do it, it would just completely, the relationship would not
he's be able perfect to continue. In all ways.
I can just be like, fuck you, stop annoying me. He's like, cool, buddy.
Half my texts to him start with the word remind.
Yeah, it's brutal.
Or reminder.
And I ignore all of them.
Yes.
Until it becomes a critical issue.
Brandon, who's your beckon guy? It used to be Katie Statz.
No, I don't.
No, it was definitely Katie Statz.
Oh, no, you got beckon guy.
She's out. She's no longer a beckon guy. I don't
Connor,
have.
Ebo.
Connor Griffin is.
Yeah. Ebo's closer to a beckon guy.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You have Megan making money bring you food onto the yak.
Well,
that's true.
You just gotta have a food person too. Beckham person, food person.
Connor Griffin will preempt it, like jump out in front of being Beckham and just do it.
Yeah, Connor correct. Is. Yeah.
Has Connor, he ever he challenged either of you in any way?
Oh no.
Pushback?
No, no. We get it. We, in fact,
Connor's our Che.
We were fucking with him. We said that Ebo was paying his own way to come out here for mostly sports, and Connor had to look up. Like there was like a 10-minute stretch where he was like. Fuck, I gotta buy a flight to Vegas.
Yeah, yeah.
He would have.
No, Connor, I had to have a meeting with Connor last week because he's overworked. Yeah. And we went through the whole list and he's working 200 hours in a work week.
Yeah.
dude, you gotta figure out how to make it more manageable here.
Yeah.
He literally listed it all and I was like, you just counted more hours than there are. That's him.
Yeah, he'll just text us randomly on before shows, it's 20 minutes before we're starting a show, and he's just like, had a snafu at the pet store today. We'll be there as soon as possible. And we just look at each other like, what the fuck is he have cooking? And then he's like, I had an idea, not doing the idea. It was a huge mishap. What is he talking about?
I got a job at a pet store.
That's the Connor Griffin experience. He just preemptively is cooking up something, and we're like, what? But it always delivers.
And he would say snafu.
Yeah.
It was just snafu a lot.
Does he say snafu?
I'm almost certain.
Yeah.
It's a great word.
God love him.
It's quick snafu.
He should be here Friday, though, because we kind of hinted heavily that if he cared about the show, he'll find
out. He's going to come. Ultimate beckon.
Yeah.
You're beckoning him across the country.
I don't think he has to be, but if I know Connor, he'll be here for
No, Connor's, Connor's watching. Connor, bud, enjoy your week off. Enjoy your vacation sitting on your ass.
The thing is, we're having Dr. Britt Baker on the show on Friday, and she took a picture and put it on Twitter. She's a wrestler. She put it on Twitter.
And dentist.
Doctor?
Yeah, Dr. Britt Baker.
What is she doctor?
She's a dentist.
I don't think
that's so that's not a doctor.
That's not a doctor. Well, that's absolutely a doctor. Anyway.
No, that's not a doctor. That's a dentist.
It's a dentist.
Well, it's Dr. Britt Baker, DMD. She's a dentist.
But she should...
She's a doctor. Is a doctor.
This is stolen valor.
Isaac Yankum was Isaac Yankum DDS. He wasn't Dr. Isaac Yankum.
Yes, exactly.
Well, he was also
I think she's an actual dentist.
She is a dentist. Right, she has a dental practice.
But you're not a doctor. You don't get a doctorate. Look at her header.
You don't call a dentist a doctor.
That's all the proof.
No, you don't.
You don't. Dentist. You don't say I'm going to the doctor.
No.
You don't say you're going to the doctor.
But if you're at the dentist,
it's in the title.
At the dentist.
I call my dentist Dr. Posey. That was my dentist growing up.
No.
Dr. Posey.
No.
That was. You don't call your dentist doctor. Yes, you do.
No, you don't. They're not a doctor. It's not medical school. They don't go to medical school. You go to dental school.
Yeah,
Walker's right. You call him Dr. Blank.
Yeah.
No, you don't. That's in their title.
No, it's not.
It's on their badge.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. A dentist is prefaced with Dr. Blank in their last name.
What do you call your dentist if you don't call him Dr.
A dentist.
Stan? What do you call him?
They earned it.
Yes, they
earned the
job.
No, they didn't go to medical school. See? They went to dentist school.
But it's
dentist. What does it say? Dentist.
It says dentist. Dentist. That's you, though. You call him doctor.
No.
I guarantee you the people in that building call that guy doctor.
On their LinkedIn, it's doctor.
No, they don't.
It absolutely is.
Doctors are not dentists. That's a thing. I think this was in the movie. No, one practices medicine, one practices dentistry. They are both doctors.
They are both doctors.
But it's doctor just means you have a doctorate in something. And they don't have a doctorate. They went to dentistry school.
So a PhD.
You calling your dentist?
What do you think CDS is? A doctorate in dental stuff.
He might be in the middle of doing doctor stuff.
They don't do shit. They just look at the teeth and say, yep.
Yep, looks good.
The hygienist does all the work.
Did we have the same dentist? My dentist was a twin. They were both dentists.
No, mine was.
Hey, you're live on the app. Quick question. Does anyone call you doctor?
Sometimes.
But you're a dentist.
Yeah, but sometimes. I don't introduce myself that way.
But do people in your office call you doctor?
Yes, always.
Oh, God damn it. All right, you failed.
This
right,
was
bye.
The easiest win of
all. That was Rhode Island versus George Washington.
Damn it.
I was wrong. I'll go hand up.
Hand up. I was wrong.
You got exposed as not going to the dentist very often.
I actually do. Well.
No, he just doesn't respect his dentist.
That's what, yeah.
T- Damn it.
But you're right, Kyle. The hygienist does it, and the doctor...
The hygienist...
The doctor does all the work. The doctor doesn't do it. The dentist does it.
The dentist comes in with, like, a mirror and is like...
Correct. Oh, yeah.
Everybody in that building, when the dentist walks in, hey, doctor. Hey, Dr. Sanderson.
That's because they're in the industry.
Hey, Dr.
That's
all right. Deep into all right. If, so, if somebody collapses on a plane, is there a doctor on board?
Is the dentist
standing up?
No, I think Brandon's like, right. Unfortunately, I have to put my hand up.
I can pull his wisdom teeth for him.
I'm going to say right now, I was wrong.
I don't like that.
Because I have dentists in my family, and they disrespect them because they're not full doctors.
Right.
I was wrong.
But I was wrong.
I was wrong. He said it. The whole office calls him doctor.
No, I'm not. I disagree still.
You're also wrong.
No, I'm going down with the ship on this one.
You can't go down with the ship. They've already bailed. There's no ship left.
Yeah, we jumped off the ship.
The ship's still going
down.
So where are you at? I think technically they're doctors, but so are PhD guys. You call your college professor, does that mean a doctor?
So is Dr. Dre.
It's doctors.
You kind of do. You call
it's
him
all
doctor.
Yeah. The point stands that...
Dr. Umar, Dr. Dre, these are, you know...
Doctors. Dr. Phil.
Dr. Phil.
Dr. Oz.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, she's coming on the show on Friday.
The dentist.
You're staying firm?
I'm staying firm. Yeah, she's a dentist.
That's fucked up, because I'm taking the L.
Why don't you call Britt Baker?
You should.
I'm with you.
It's ambiguous nomenclature. Yeah. It's,
all right. So Titus is just.
He's going down with the ship.
I'll take the L, but like I'm going.
No, he's
down.
Going down with the ship.
Sounds like I'm taking the L. Sounds like I'm taking all the L.
No, I'm taking a lot of L. I went.
You're taking the forfeit L. I'm taking like the we're down 10 with 20 seconds left.
You're still calling timeouts.
And I'm still calling timeouts and pressing.
Kyle, you got rouged when this was going on.
I got rouged.
You were red in the face.
I'm red in the face.
No, it was a different hue than you are right now.
Oh, yeah. I got excited.
It's nice.
Sometimes you guys just say stupid things, and I just let it go all the time. And finally, like, yeah, I'm
sucks,
challenge your opinion.
Do you ever say stupid stuff?
My dentist rocks, and now I don't think I can.
Now he knows you don't respect him.
Yeah.
So I don't know if Kyle ever does say stupid stuff.
Not really.
Oh, you actually
do. Yeah. It's kind of an Achilles heel of mine.
Achilles.
Kind of.
When was the last time Kyle said something stupid?
He doesn't do it. He's infallible.
You've said some dumb shit that got you lampooned on the Bachelor subreddit.
Yeah.
That's it.
He's like Kyle's like a, what is it, Jack Russell Terrier?
Much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's just sharper than all of us. We're all just big, dumb lads.
Muscular, athletic.
Yeah, and he's just
You can tell he's smart.
He won't run for a tennis ball.
No.
Like, I see it in your hand, and we're just running down the...
You can put food on his nose, and he won't eat it.
Yeah.
Like, you can balance a treat right here.
What is the dog breed of all of us?
That's a good question.
I'm a basset hound. I got big ears.
Yeah.
And you just bay.
Mm-hmm. Lazy.
I don't know. Che, you're probably a shih tzu.
Sharpay.
I might be like a fat pit bull.
A fat pit bull?
Where you're like...
Are there fat pit bulls?
Nah, yeah. I don't think...
No, there are fat pit bulls.
Yeah, but you don't have the edge.
So what
you've never
known like that. You're like an American bulldog.
Yeah. That's too small, though.
Oh, it's too small.
Che might
be like the dumbest lab.
Che might be a retriever.
Chow chow.
Yeah, that's true. I can see that.
Yeah, Che could be a retriever.
You're just agreeing with everything that's being
said. He's agreed with every single dog, which is very retriever-like.
Yes, that's very golden retriever.
Che. Oh, okay.
I heard throwing something at me.
Yeah, fuck.
So she's coming on the show Friday.
Okay, all right. Okay. back to what we're talking about.
So she's coming on the show Friday, and she last week tweeted out a picture of her loving Tate McRae, the new pop star. Right?
Yeah, what is she known for other than being hot?
Something, singing something.
Okay.
Anyway, Connor Griffin loves Tate McRae. Connor Griffin knows that Britt is going to be on the show, and he has demanded to be on the show to FaceTime her just to have a conversation about Tate McRae. And he has offered to possibly come out here and do it in person, just to talk to her about Tate McRae.
This woman just is a fan of Tate McRae?
Yeah, she's a fan. That's all he knows about her. She's a fan, and he only wants to interview her to talk about her love of Tate McRae.
He can do that now.
That doesn't feel like a flyout. He shouldn't.
I agree. I don't think he should, but if I know Connor, he will be here.
Yeah, I guess he just doesn't like Tate McRae that much.
Yeah.
I hope Tate doesn't.
What if the dentist is like
I'm not that big of a fan of her.
Then yes, yeah, that would be the funniest way to fuck with him.
She might. Like, I just like one of her songs.
She's like, I just, it was virtue signaling. I felt like if I was a fan of her, people would love me more. So I just, I just said I was.
Was Tate McRae one of the women at the Laker game that was fawning over
him? Yeah, she's okay, 20 years old.
That was his Super Bowl that he tweeted.
Okay.
About.
Okay, was it Olivia Rodrigo was there too?
Yeah.
Because he loves, why does he love that like brand of pop star so
I
much?
I don't know.
Is Connor like a teenage girl?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, or
we've got a picture of him at a Drake concert.
No, Drake Bell.
Drake Bell.
Not Drake.
Not Drake.
That's still Drake.
Oh, that's Bell. A funny picture.
Drake Bell.
Drake
Bell.
Yeah, you got to say Bell there.
With the Hug Me Brother sign.
Okay, so he's the only dude in the crowd.
Wait, did he really have the Hug Me Brother
sign?
Yeah, he
was the only guy in the crowd, and he's holding up a sign that says Hug Me Brother.
I've been the only guy at a concert before, too.
What concert?
98 Degrees. I had Nick painted on my face. For Lachey, not me. For Lachey.
Oh, the word?
My dad brought me, yeah.
Not even a picture?
No, N-I-C-K, and I was wearing a bucket hat. My dad brought me, and he was so mad. They came out of tubes. It was so sick.
Did you see Lachey's recent attempt to woo?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe we can watch that?
He's getting back into the woo game. It's tough to get back in once you leave.
Oh, it's bad.
He's singing with full throat, too.
Yeah.
Like, he should be singing that kind of softly and nicely.
Really cringy.
What was the song that he, what was the song he covered?
I don't know, but he's like trying to make it every Monday where he puts out a song.
It was something, what was it? Was it John Mayer?
No, it was like a recent song.
Probably Puth.
So who's he trying to woo?
I don't know, internet.
He's just trying to get a fresh crop.
There's the Hug Me Brother.
Yeah.
Oh my god! Brother.
Oh man! Oh man!
Just all girls.
That's Connor.
Well, I'm just shocked Drake Bell has that many. What's the symbol they make for Drake Bell?
This is at
Illuminati.
High school. This is a high school.
That's high school.
This is Connor's high school, and that's their high school like hand signal.
What is that?
I think you'd be better off just yelling to us at this point.
Is this Illuminati or is this a vagina?
Is that Drake Bell?
That's oh, they're making, I don't think the girls would be doing vaginas.
Drake
not,
Bell.
Be like,
don't let Dante see this.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Why?
Because
Illuminati.
Are they making a...
I actually think that the Illuminati's behind the whole Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce thing at this point. Just want that on the record.
So is he worth a flyer on MVP for plus 1,200?
Yes. Yeah.
Because
Illuminati.
Yeah.
And if they win, he retires after this game. Goes into acting.
Does he propose?
No.
I want him to so bad because I want all the Swifties to like everything I know about the Swifties, they would be disgusted about being proposed to at a football game.
Yeah.
So like if he did like a third quarter like Jumbotron.
Yeah. Third quarter.
Yeah.
Hey Taylor.
Like points to the sign.
And they'd all be like, that was so sweet. Like, no, you don't think that.
Yeah.
2007 or 2008 Fiesta Bowl, Boise State, Oklahoma.
Yes.
Ian Johnson. Was
Ian
it?
Johnson. Uh-huh. Yeah.
When I didn't watch it live, he proposed. Was that on TV?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it was very dumb of him.
The reporter spoiled it.
Yeah. What?
The reporter was like, I got Ian Johnson. Now here's girlfriend, and he's got a special proposal to make.
Oh.
And then she looked at the reporter like,
that could mean anything.
But I feel like that was such a, he ruined it because, like, if you beating Oklahoma in the Fiesta Bowl is like instant head. But then you propose, now you have to have sex.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
That doesn't seem like the worst thing.
Wait. All right.
Yeah. Like, if you propose, like, I feel like you have to have sex, not you don't get head.
You're saying that.
You don't think
that's a burden for him?
Yeah, he got free head.
No.
He threw it away for
sex. But you don't think the Fiesta was sex?
When that guy proposed to Hillary Duff,
yes,
she sucked
yes,
his dick
yes,
on that balcony.
Yes. Yeah. That's what I was trying to think of.
What?
Was it Mike Comrie?
Yes.
Mike Comrie
proposed, and she
okay,
dropped
right.
right there.
That's interesting.
On the balcony, didn't
and there's care who there's saw. Like paparazzi pictures of it.
Okay,
so Kyle, you sounded jealous as fuck.
Hillary Duff, there's like footage,
stills.
Stills, yeah.
Stills of her.
There's no. You can't see. You can just see her dropping.
You just see a ponytail emerging.
That was probably a huge ring.
Had to have been.
The Boise guy probably had a fucking
tiny little ring.
Tiny ring. Yeah.
There's no. This is pre-NIL. So
yeah. Right. I don't think he's getting his dick sucked for that.
I think you just got to separate your highs. If you beat Oklahoma,
right.
Yes, we'll separate the highs.
Yeah, he just
wait another day.
Combined it. Now yeah. It's like she gets to celebrate, like it's like her night,
mm-hmm.
But it's your night.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Was he planning like to do it if they lost?
Good question. That I actually would be okay with because then you, like, going by the Stephen Shea principle, if you can't get hard after a loss.
Yeah.
But you want to have sex.
No, but that's why he did it, is because by doing it that way, losing wasn't ever an option. He put extra pressure on
it.
He was like, I'm going to buy this ring. Mm-hmm. He wasn't going to try to win the game yeah. until...
I think so.
He carried in his sock?
I don't know. Maybe an equipment manager carried it around the whole game?
I'm going to propose at Kyle's wedding.
I wouldn't care.
I know. I know you don't like the spotlight.
Yeah, I would love that.
I'm going to announce him running for president at Kyle's wedding.
Yeah, all right.
Well, that would be best case scenario.
Brandon
is a bunch of people do a bunch of people do things that overshadow the attention of it.
Oh, man. Steven, rip off a couple ads.
Yep. You did Mango Wires.
Singers and Raising Cane's.
Let me do these. Okay.
Yeah. Do the Raising Cane's just so I could eat some of it.
Sure. Raising Cane's, the Chiefs and 49ers are locked in, and Raising Cane's will absolutely be your chicken finger choice for the big game. We're just days away from the very large Sunday game. And we're going to be sure to have Cane's at our Barstool party. We're streaming it from Gambling Cave, right? And Cane's is, of course, a sponsor there. You already know we're going to have it for tailgates. They're hand-battered, cooked-to-order chicken fingers, buttery Texas toast, get the Bob butter on both sides, and, of course, their crispy, crinkle-cut fries, all of which is perfect with their secret recipe Cane's sauce. I don't know what the Cane's sauce is, but it is really good.
It's incredible. Delicious,
yeah.
It's kind of like a
shit. Pink
issue. It's very, very tasty.
Yeah, there's a...
Okay, well, wait till he does the ads.
Go to RaisingCane's.com to check it all out. Make sure that you have your order in time ahead of the game on Sunday. Just remember to get it early. They'll be closing 30 minutes after kickoff to watch the game, too. So satisfy your Cane's fix today. There's really no other options. Again, go to RaisingCane's.com to order your chicken fingers. Best in the world.
There's a man climbing the sphere.
Right now.
Can we see
the anti-abortion guy?
Anti-abortion Spider-Man?
Yeah.
Oh, that guy climbed New York Times, right?
A bunch of shit.
He hates abortion venom.
He's on top? He did it? Yeah. Oh, he already did it. Oh,
abortion sick. Doc Ock would be so efficient.
Abortion Doc Ock. Get it done so fast.
As big as them.
I know Doc Ock.
That wasn't as cool as I thought it was going to be.
No.
Wait.
That was kind of a dud.
Wait, so what's that guy's plan now?
Just climb it, and then everyone slide says, down. Hey, then they interview him,
slide
and he's like,
down?
No abortions.
That's how they do it.
Yeah, getting down seems difficult for
harder.
Me.
Harder.
You gotta slide down.
Slide. Oh, there
the
he
best
goes.
Way to be pro-life is to risk yours. Yeah, is he going to slide? Where is he?
I don't see him.
Is this live right now?
Oh, Sphere's fine.
Sphere should really troll him right now and just put a bunch of messaging that he doesn't believe in.
Yeah, they could really.
Wait, is it actually the Spider-Man abortion guy?
Yeah, I assume. He does this everywhere.
Oh, yeah, he did it last year at the Super Bowl in Phoenix.
Yeah. Yeah, they could easily do it right now being like, abortion's cool.
Yeah, playing paranoid.
And we're just watching him.
And he's just on it.
Abortion's cool.
The Sphere is sick. Yeah. It blew my mind.
I know. I want to go bad.
Did you see the magician yet?
Oh, I bought it for the wrong day.
I saw a billboard for him.
Bought it for the wrong day.
So are you staying or no?
Well, my flight's on Friday.
So that's a no.
If anybody's here and wants to see Shin Lim.
He's just a magician, right?
You said just a magician?
He's just a run of the
He's
mill.
A master of smoke and cloud.
Yeah, you can have my room.
You don't want to. Right.
Well, I want to see Shin Lim.
I'm sure you'll have other chances to see Shin Lim.
Never.
Is he tour?
No.
In Vegas for a whole week and you didn't see Shin Lim?
This is probably the best chance you'll ever have.
That's a big mistake.
You could just probably.
Yeah, we'll talk, yeah.
Buy him another night.
They were really expensive.
Yeah. How expensive?
Like you could get smoke on you.
Do you want to go?
You're in the splash zone.
Do you want to go tonight or tomorrow? I'll buy you tickets.
What the fuck?
No, don't. No.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, wait.
Just don't want him to buy
you
tickets.
And then I'll give Shin Lim to somebody random. I'll do a philanthropy.
No.
I want to go up to a homeless guy, just be like, hey, man.
He's like, I'm starving. I got you one better.
Let me see Shin Lim tickets. Shin Lim tickets.
Have you guys noticed any new terms in the Barstool lexicon of late.
Like a word Dave says, then everybody starts saying?
Yes.
Mm-mm.
Like Banana Land and stuff like that.
Is there a new
shit,
one?
Shit, he's not
wild.
Wait, no.
Why? Yeah.
He's performing tomorrow night.
What are we doing?
A dozen.
Here?
Dozen.
Fuck.
Yeah, now we're booked.
No, I'll give the tickets to a bum.
I'll give you my hotel room.
What have you noticed, Ron?
Two. I've noticed saying people have a big dump in their pants.
Oh.
Mm.
And then also.
That's Peter McNeely, though.
Is it?
Wasn't that?
I don't remember that.
It's flying around. And then the other one is correct. When people correct. Say correct.
One of the worst
correct. I think I've always said that.
One of the worst things that happened to Barstool was the 100%
win. Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
I don't like
swept me up.
What are we even doing here?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, that was wild. That's wild.
Well, a lot of people like have
that.
Just
that was Riggs.
I like that.
Oh, that was specifically Riggs, but a lot of people throw around wild like that.
People are throwing around genuinely like it's some intellectual
correct.
What has Balls got on up? What has he got in his rotation now?
Balls live stream playing Connect Four with one of his big-breasted women, and I just that would be the funniest podcast to catch somebody just listening to.
Yeah,
audio podcast. Yeah.
He's really big into Mediterranean food recently.
Mm. Oh,
well, he's always gone to
Cava.
Place
Nava, not
Naya.
Naya.
But he's like trying to do 2 weeks sober.
2 weeks?
Yeah. He's in the middle of a 2 week stretch and he's been like massively big into Mediterranean food. Like he's loving Mediterranean food. It's his favorite type
That's his new
right
booze.
Now. Yeah. It's a Mediterranean food, a branzino or a baba ganoush, tzatziki, halloumi.
Hummus.
Yeah. Nice hummus.
Who says dump in your pants?
A lot of people.
On Twitter?
I found the clip. TJ, can you play it? I think it is Peter McNeely, the guy who Tyson fought right when he got out of jail and killed him in like a minute.
Like 20 seconds, right?
Yeah.
Against a white guy, give him a chance too.
Oh, he's incredible.
Keep laughing. They're real funny, huh? If any one of you doesn't respect me, or what I'm doing or what I've been doing for the last 3 months since it's been announced. And going against a guy like this, you'd have a big dump in your pants.
He nailed it.
Burn him.
You got a big dump in your pants. Yes, that plays.
Never right. A good sign if you're a boxer and at the press conference everybody laughs at you.
Yeah, and you're just yelling at the reporters instead of
keep
the
laughing.
Guy you're fighting.
But I think you could have played a drinking game on Surviving Barstool when people said correct.
Correct?
Correct was correct. Flying around. Correct.
Yeah, I think you're right.
1,000% was the other one. It went from 100 to 1,000.
Wait, it's 1,000%?
It was, yeah. I think it's slowly weeded out.
I want to start one.
Yeah, let's start one.
What's a phrase?
Mm.
I like that.
Mm.
You like what's a phrase?
Roll with that,
Or.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Disc. No.
Wordless phrase.
No.
No.
Dentist.
George Kittle's calling.
Book was fun.
Let Kyle get it.
Book got nothing.
No, that's not true.
Book got nothing.
No, people were throwing Book at.
People, no one used Book.
It was in like the comment section of like Son of a Boy Dad.
They were saying Book.
They were saying Book. Yeah.
Damn.
You just didn't push it hard enough.
Yeah, we gotta start throwing.
You have to.
You just
gotta
fully
it.
Commit.
Yeah, you have. You guys have not done a good. You've
but
been in the work.
We don't time. Even know. I don't even know when to use Book. To be honest.
Yeah. Right.
There's not a lot of situations. I do know when to use it. Just not a lot of situations.
Like on the trip, when would have been a time Steven could have used Book?
Does Book mean like buy the book?
Textbook.
Exactly.
Oh, textbook.
Oh yeah, I don't even know.
I guess textbook's already a thing.
Mm.
Like that's textbook?
A textbook, yeah, yeah.
Oh, we need your help with
that. Have you heard this one?
What's that? No, what's this?
What are you watching right now?
He's saying,
What did he just say? Wait,
that shit cracks me up.
Wait, what is it?
He's saying, brother,
Is that a Muslim brother? Is that a Sunni brother?
Yeah, I don't know what the situation is.
Situation. Oh my God.
I think you should drive back, Jay.
Yeah.
No.
Drive back by yourself.
It wasn't a punishment.
I couldn't do it.
Compare and contrast.
Or have Connor come out and you guys drive back.
Yeah.
With no music.
Connor, Jay, do you always drive with your hands like this?
Yeah, Jay and white Jay.
No. Sometimes I'll do this.
No, you don't.
You were right.
You don't sometimes do that.
If I'm in like the my town, like a, but if yeah, if I'm on the highway, I'm going like 90 miles an hour. Yeah, I'm.
You were up.
You were like
you
this.
Were here.
You were like way too safe.
You look like Tua.
You're an oxymoron.
I was like this.
Yeah.
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 Was I looking back?
No.
No.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe. I mean, I'm not known for good driving, so
no,
whatever.
No, duh.
No, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go like this, are you consciously trying to look cool, or do you just is that just comfortable to you?
Just laid back.
Did anybody criticize your driving?
No.
How many hours did you drive?
I can only do like 4-hour shifts. I think I did like two.
What?
Why can you only do 4-hour shifts?
I did.
What are you?
I get like very uncomfortable. My back tightens up, and then I gotta like.
Oh, I can go.
This guy's a pussy.
I can go 14 hours. Yeah.
Yeah.
You do that often.
I love doing long drives. Yeah. Six hours is nothing.
Great thinking time.
Yeah.
Really? Oh. I can sit in the back, but just like being locked.
I can't sit in the back.
You can't sit in the back?
I'll go crazy.
I can't either.
What? Mm-hmm. I don't like sitting in the back.
I can't sit in the back.
I'm riding. You get car sick or?
I do.
Yeah, sit in the back.
You know, given we knew what the punishment was for a while, who'd be your least desirable person to lose? And he
no, I saw
you.
Yeah.
What?
Me and Frank would have gotten along swimmingly.
Steven, are there ever times when you drive with your family and you don't drive?
Passenger what princess?
Mean, like my wife will drive?
Yeah.
Sometimes. We'll
she have her hand on your thigh?
Oh, this is bad.
I haven't ridden in a car my wife has driven since 2007.
Yeah.
I drive 100%.
Your wife hasn't driven a car with you in it since 2007.
You also don't let her show her face.
No. I think I've done it maybe twice, and it's because I was drunk.
Yeah.
Pregnant.
I was drunk in 2007. Yeah. I never let my wife drive.
Yeah.
Does she have a car?
She drives herself. I never let her drive if I'm in there.
You drive her car, you drive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I drive both cars.
Out of respect, like, I'm...
I got to drive.
The last thing men have.
Oh, because you need... Yeah.
I want to drive.
They took everything from us.
No.
They're trying to take Shane Gillis from us again.
They're trying to cancel him for hosting the show that he got canceled for.
Yeah.
That's double jeopardy.
Yeah. You can't be tried for that.
You can't recancel.
You can't recancel. He's already been canceled for that.
Right.
There's no precedent for this, though.
Yeah.
We do have boots on the ground fighting for Shane Gillis on TMZ.
This is just...
I feel like I'm in Charlie Brown's class.
This is a fucking disaster.
It's very funny. That does not work. Talk to us.
All right.
Just say what you said. We'll say.
Greer's
going on TMZ to talk about Shane Gillis.
Oh,
yes. Hell yeah.
Greer's going on TMZ to talk about Shane Gillis.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. That'll be great.
Rowan, you hit a fucking tumbleweed with D-Lo today?
I know, dude. It was terrible.
It was a doozy. I didn't know tumbleweeds were so big.
It was, and it most of it was under the car in that picture. Like when it was in front of us, it was like as square and as tall as the car, like a rolled up bale of hay.
That's scary to do damage to the car.
That's a big boy.
Well, it's mostly under the car.
To the car?
No, but
you had to stop?
Somebody's knocking at the door. This feels like Pee Wee's Playhouse.
We're doing
I love Pee Wee's
Playhouse. I ain't getting it.
Yeah.
Come in.
Adventure's one of the best.
Come in.
Yeah, go get it, Che.
I like braced my core, I braced for impact. Like
yeah.
Lawrence Fishburne was on Pee Wee's Playhouse.
Yeah, he was. He was the
cowboy.
What happened to the car?
Nothing.
Cowboy Curtis.
Cowboy Curtis and Keanu Reeves was Cherry.
That's not true.
No.
Cherry was a girl.
Cherry was a girl.
Cherry was a girl.
No way.
Cherry was a girl. Cherry was
Who
female.
Is it? Who is it?
Wasn't
Nobody.
Cherry female? Because it had lips.
I mean, it was a fucking chair.
Yeah, but it had lipstick lips.
I got lips. Am I a girl?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Do we have merch here, by the way? Because I ran out of sweatshirts. I'll just run them back.
No, I packed horribly.
Because after I got wet yesterday, there was nothing for me.
Really?
Mm-mm.
You're not thinking of Jambi?
Mm-mm. I'm thinking of Cherry. The chair.
Yeah, but the chair had lips.
I didn't pack enough clothes, and I just had to roll around in the dirt in the desert with Feitelberg.
Oh, you guys did it out of order?
No, he just wanted to do that with me.
Oh, okay, nice.
Yeah, there is still dirt on your hat.
Is there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you guys see Mincy's tweet last night that he had to edit?
Yes.
The best.
He edits a lot of tweets.
He edits, and he doesn't realize that you can still see the edited tweet.
What did he say?
TJ pulled up. Here it is.
He's getting his forearm rubbed again.
He's getting his forearm rubbed, and he says, next time we're going to beat those damn cocks. getting his forearm rubbed.
There's a new version of this pet.
Change it to Gamecocks.
Did you see the video, though? Because she does look like she's being held hostage.
Yeah, show us the video. I don't understand. Is this what he just does?
Oh, I'm going to make you famous.
What if Mincy never, like, he can't come in sex? He can only do it with getting his arm rubbed, and he's getting all these women to do this to him?
Yeah.
Man, I don't even want to think about that.
What is going on? What is this video?
You almost lost earlier. I know one thing for sure. Next time.
How did he ask her to do this?
We're going to beat those damn Gamecocks.
She's not breaking her eye contact either. It's crazy.
Oh, he's. Dude. What?
Field.
That probably is nice for guys to spend that much time on our phones. There's probably something weird happening to our elbows and forearms.
Yeah, you're right. That's a good point.
What did you, would you shock today? In the gym.
Oh, full body. Yeah.
Anything specific? Anything fun?
The incline goes up to 30 degrees, which is double the standard treadmill. So that was fun.
Oh, Kate just sent us a text that the guy on top of the sphere now doesn't know how to get back down.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, he's on a big sphere.
Who could have seen this coming?
I'm. How did he climb it, though?
He's got the suction cups.
So why can't he suction back down?
Yeah, I'll say this right now. I don't care. Maybe this is controversial. Anytime someone does something like this, I hope they die.
You hope they die, or you don't care if they die?
Yeah, I'd say don't care.
Yeah.
Oh, do you hope? You do it like you hope.
Like when the Willendas do that shit, I was rooting for him to die.
Really?
Is that fucked?
A little bit.
I don't know. Like, that's just like, people shouldn't do that.
Daredevils?
Yeah, no, I don't like it.
Nobody should have rooted for
Evel. I think it's morally incorrect.
How did Evel Knievel die?
Do daredevil stunts.
Right? And then have someone come save you. It's like when the people like try to swim like across the English Channel, and then everyone has got to go save, the Coast Guard's got to go save them.
Because it's baiting the devil? You don't like that?
All right, maybe I don't hope. But actually, I can't.
Yeah, you do. Don't lie to me.
Yeah, I can't lie to myself.
What about like monster trucks?
That's different.
Those are safe.
That's totally
well, okay. So
monster
then, what
trucks
about,
are safe?
What
no, monster no. trucks? You're putting on a show for the people.
Yeah.
There's an actual
putting on a show.
No, that's not a show.
I don't like it when people disrupt other people's shit.
Correct.
So Willenda. Correct.
Like, correct. 100%.
Oh yeah, they didn't even realize.
100%.
Like
people who protest in the highway.
Yep. If a stunt delayed my plane, mad.
Right.
Yeah. Mad.
It's banana land.
Right. So, well, what about the two dudes? What about the guy who went man on a wire between the two World Trade Towers?
Mm-hmm.
You wanted him to die?
Yes.
Really?
I think so.
Yeah, he's an asshole.
He was French. I wanted him to die. Because
beforehand.
Yeah.
The Alex Honnold, the free solo guy.
I don't want
he's
him
an exception die. Because no. I think he's the greatest athlete of all time.
But he's also not doing it for, like, he's not doing it.
He's also
like,
dead.
He doesn't. He neurologically needs
wait,
to do
dead? It. He's dead?
Wait, no. The free solo guy died, right?
No.
I'm thinking of a different one. I'm thinking of a different one.
No, that's also a very different thing. They're doing it for sport, and they're not doing it to like stop the world.
What about Grizzly Man? Were you happy he died?
Yes, not happy.
Remind me again.
Grizzly Man was the one that got mauled and eaten by a grizzly.
He lived
with the grizzly.
He thought he had like some superior.
It was not his friend Grizzly. It was the bad grizzly.
I did not hope he died, but I also don't. I can't shed a tear.
You can't. Yeah, you can't be shocked.
But he kind of.
When somebody does something risky, you can. So I don't want to say it's tough to be sad, but it's tough to be like,
there's risk that is for like our entertainment that I'm not hoping for those people to die.
Like NASCAR.
Yeah, like they're doing a sport. Like I'm not hoping for them to die.
What about Super X? What about Super X when they're doing a massive jump?
I don't want them to die. It's just the people who are like doing it for like some cause and stopping everyone else, and then we have to use public good to like save them.
And that puts other people in danger.
Right, like a helicopter's got to go save that asshole. Fuck that.
Because like lifeguards, if there's somebody out in like a place where they're not supposed to go, lifeguards won't even go out there to save you, right?
Yeah, I think I'm right on this take.
I think lifeguards are allowed to be like, if I'm going to die doing it, I'm not going to.
KB's
this guy, I would love to have someone help me out.
I don't like this guy.
Okay.
So yeah.
Hope is a strong word.
Hope is.
I guess I'm not praying for
him. So what's going to happen? He's going to need a helicopter?
Probably.
I'm not praying for him to die. I guess maybe it's more just that if he dies, I will not care what's
going on. Why couldn't a helicopter just...
pluck him?
Ride up to the sills of the Twin Towers and save people.
I saw that yesterday.
The smoke?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't...
Also,
is it hard?
Is it harder than we thought?
I didn't get that much notice.
I think helicopters are more difficult than we thought.
Yeah.
But the guy who went between the two World Trade Towers, the Frenchman, who man on wire, he didn't need anyone to save him. He just did it and got across, and he was also a great athlete.
How did he die?
Wait, so he didn't die?
No.
The man on wire guy is still alive.
Yeah.
Is he still alive?
Somebody tried that stunt, though, and failed, right?
I don't think so.
Not recently.
TJ, look up failed stunts.
I don't think anybody tried it
the millennium.
23 years or so.
Oh, I don't know why. Oh, shit.
Still alive.
Oh, good for him. Philip Petit.
Oh, that's why he's doing it.
PP Petit.
Uh-huh.
That's badass.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty cool.
And nobody got hurt, and he didn't waste anybody's time.
I bet you somebody got fired.
Was that planned?
Yes.
A security guard lost his job, for sure.
They planned it. They snuck in. They shot like a bow and arrow across.
Planned like the Willendas, where like they stopped everything and did it.
No.
No, they just did it in the middle.
Chase him, but because he's in between the wires, he walked over to a cop and then walked back.
Yeah, that was sick.
Badass, okay. Yeah.
But it sucks that he's French.
Oh, it's the worst.
People in Alaska hate that Into the Wild guy.
Really?
Yes. Chris McCandless, I think was his name.
Yeah, he does have some critics. Like,
not everybody, but there was a lot of.
Well, you put like other like the police go look for you, like, you know, rescue people.
But I guess there's a lot of copycat. Like, people weren't trying to die, but they were just like inspired by his story.
Right.
So they're like, I want to go to
he's
Denali.
He's also famous because he failed.
And just
like, if he got back, it would have been no one would care.
What's wrong, Brandon?
Ooh, Dad.
Wake up,
Brandon. You just hit yourself.
Trying to wake up.
Wow.
That book cover for Into the Wild had the ending of the book on the cover.
Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah.
What do you want to talk about, Ruby? You want to name running backs or something?
I'm just struggling.
You want to name running backs?
Who's the best quarterback in the SEC coming in next year?
You want to do a sports grid? You want to do a grid?
No, we don't have to do a grid.
Let's wake you up. No, let's wake you up with just guys' names.
Can we slap?
No,
say some names.
Do we need a Sporkle?
You want to do a Sporkle?
All right, let's do a Sporkle.
Sporkle's not going
to
really.
No, let's do a Sporkle how we used to always do it, where you go around and then if you can't get it, then you're out.
Then you're out.
You want to talk about Cool Spot?
The 7-Up
mascot?
Yeah,
let's talk about Cool Spot.
That video game was good on Sega Genesis.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah, he used to walk around snapping his fingers.
Cool Spot is the red dot between the 7
and
up.
You didn't know who he was.
Sweet tea. Some sweet tea.
There's some over there, I think.
Yeah, go
get some sweet tea.
Get some sweet tea.
Get some sweet tea. We'll do a Sporkle. We'll get you wakened up. Hey, girl.
I was actually going to say.
He absolutely would say that. Girl over there. Hey, girl two.
McCarthy.
D-Lo, can we get Brandon some sweet tea?
Wait, what are we doing?
Thank you.
We're going to do a Sporkle and get you some sweet tea.
We're going to get you some sweet tea. We're going to do a Sporkle round.
I'm going to have a chicken tender.
We're going to get you a forearm massage, a Sporkle, some sweet tea, and get you woke up.
Right. Are we calling Jeff D-Lo now?
D-Lo.
Just D-Lo?
Yeah.
That's too cool. That's too cool of a name.
Like Brown.
Oh,
yeah,
there we go.
That like makes
not to be confused
awesome.
With CeeLo Green, but D'Lo Brown.
He's a Browns fan. I tried to get D'Lo Browns for him. Didn't stay.
He doesn't need the cup.
You're not a nickname guy, Shay.
I'm not a name guy.
I don't know.
No, I don't think you could name.
That kind of worked. D'Lo Browns kind of worked.
Yeah.
Could you put down a gallon of that, Brandon?
How about we end the show when you have a gallon?
Gallon challenge.
A briefcase race.
All right, pull up a Sporkle, TJ. Let's get this boy back.
Here.
Yeah, let Kyle do it.
This is step one.
Come on.
He's weak right now. He's a sweet tea.
He's going into anaphylactic
shock. A long pull. Just give us one long.
Tea, delicious.
Brandon, you're shaking.
He started slapping himself.
Oh, my God, dude.
Why are you shaking like that, son?
That's good.
Get him some more.
I don't know. I'm good. Where are we at? Doing Sporkle?
Yeah.
Let's talk about something you want to talk about, man.
I think a Sporkle would be nice. I feel like a Sporkle, you just get to access parts of your brain. We get to go around.
Get the brain going.
Get
the brain going.
Yeah. You want to talk about figurines?
I haven't found a good place in Vegas yet to go mantiquing. Now I don't have
Let's go to Gold and Silver Pawn.
Yeah, but they don't have... That's
go
gonna
see
be expensive.
Chumlee.
That's going to be expensive stuff. I like to go... $50 limit. I like to do that.
You need to get some more Mango RX.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Mango RX.
Big shout out.
Did we do Mango RX?
Yeah, we did. Okay. We have to do Steven Singer.
Yeah.
Real quick?
Yep.
Oh, no, this is too... No, let's do... I could do. Let's do a general one.
We're not gonna
You bookmark? Can you text me that one?
No,
college football general.
No, just do general knowledge.
Grab bag.
Yeah, I do Steven Singer.
It's time to talk about our friend Steven Singer. Great name from Steven Singer Jewelers. The guy we hate. I hate Steven Singer guy. You've seen his billboards or heard him on the radio, but who hates him? Well, other jewelers hate him. Why? Because Steven has the number one gift for Valentine's Day, and we are excited to tell you about it. It's right in the middle of that table right there. It's a real long-stem American Beauty rose, lavishly and deeply dipped in pure 24-karat gold that's guaranteed to last forever. That's right. They start at just $59. This beautiful Valentine's Day rose will not wilt or die. It doesn't even need water. This is the number one gift for the big day. Something unique, special, that lasts forever. And they come with their own personalized love message in Steven's signature gift box, shipped for free. Go to IHateStevenSinger.com and see what I'm talking about. Steven Singer Jewelers, a real jeweler you can trust. That's IHateStevenSinger.com. Lasts forever. That's what you want on Valentine's Day. I got engaged on Valentine's Day. That lasts forever.
Wow.
Probably, like,
hope so.
Most people.
Yeah. All right.
We were talking about how funny it would be if you were single.
Oh, that'd be awful.
No, we were saying that we could probably get you to eat pussy live on air.
Would you do a dating show where
Why not?
Only...
It's not, you're not naked.
Would you only eat the, like, a dating show where you never met the, it's almost like Love is Blind, but you only eat the pussy. Taste is
It's Top blind. Chef's pussy.
Top Chef pussy.
Yeah. He walks into the kitchen.
Yeah.
Like a
all the women are on the table, spread eagle.
One ingredient today, boys. Yeah.
Nope.
Your ingredient's pussy. Yeah.
Your ingredient's yeast.
Chef, I made pussy. This is a beautiful spread.
This is a Thai-infused pussy. This pussy is from Nigeria.
Is Chop still taping?
That's what we're referencing, right? Okay.
Yeah.
That's what you're talking about, right?
Chop, you get Top Chef.
Top Chef. Yeah.
Top Chef.
Same thing.
Oh, okay. I don't know that program.
You don't know Top Chef?
I've never seen it, no.
Top Chef is very famous.
Chopped. I've seen Chopped.
I almost think it's the most famous cooking show.
Yeah, I would say so.
Yeah.
It's the first big one.
It's the top one.
The Great British Pussy Eating Contest.
This tastes like beans and tomatoes. All right, let's do a Sporkle. Come on, Brandon.
Caligula's got a place out here. I almost went to it.
Caligula?
Caligula.
Oh.
Tom.
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, you've got to try the pussy.
Oh, man, this is going to be tough.
Oh, boy.
Yep.
Can't read it at all. All
right, Brandon, you're starting.
Can we, I want to take a
timer
picture.
Timer or no timer?
I see Seinfeld.
No timer.
No, that doesn't say Seinfeld at all. It's the U.S. states. U.S. states.
Zoom in a little.
Here, you want me to be play-by-play guy?
Look up and read it.
Okay. New Jersey.
Show me New Jersey.
Category, Seinfeld foursome, first name only, U.S. Boring. States with the word new in their
Boring.
Name, stages of insect metamorphosis,
yep. Okay.
Still living U.S. presidents, monopoly railroads, U.S. or U.K., D. Adam.
Douglas Adams, Hitchhiker's Guide books.
Yep.
Indiana Jones movies, Greek architectural orders, and traveling Wilburys.
This is awful.
No
it's
way.
No sports.
Let's do a different one.
Yeah, that one is either too easy
after
or too
we've
hard.
We've read that. We've read it for everyone. We'll do a different one.
Was Traveling Wilburys the first supergroup?
No, I think there have been
is
others.
Is that Steve Martin?
No,
I think that's Tom Petty.
Yeah,
Tom Petty,
and
George
Orbison.
Harrison.
What's Steve
Roy
Martin?
Roy Orbison. Bob Dylan.
Oh, I was thinking of the Wild
Bob
Thornberrys.
Dylan.
Jeff Lynne.
What's Steve Martin's band?
Donnie, Eliza,
Nigel.
I am.
What was the hot one's
Sipping
name? The hot Thornberry.
Oh,
Deborah.
Yes. Debbie.
I knew you'd have me. Thank you. Yeah, it was Debbie.
One Steve female Martin. Swimmer with the most world championship gold medals.
Okay.
Three first names of the Zeller brothers in the NBA. Ooh. Three teams. Three terms. Terms on the pH scale. Four MLB teams with a color in their name. Five movies featuring Jackie Chan and the following actors.
Got it.
Oh, this is good.
Five most dangerous jobs in America, 2024, according to Forbes. Six countries with longest coastlines. Seven playable characters in the original Mortal Kombat game.
Yep. Okay.
12 flavors of stovetop stuffing.
You better not lose it.
10 movies where following actors did full frontal.
This is made for you, scene. Brandon.
You can do this whole thing by yourself.
I've never had stovetop right, in my life. You want to start?
I'll start with the swimmer, Leah Thomas.
yeah, I'll start. Red Sox.
There you go. Okay.
Who's we going left or right?
Nick.
Going right.
I'll go White Sox.
Cody Zeller.
Blue Jays.
Oh, and that clears it. Okay.
Sub-Zero.
Nice.
Me?
Yeah.
Rush Hour.
Nice.
Uh-huh. Hangover.
Forgetting Sarah Marshall.
Yeah, good job.
Great fucking movie.
Shia LaBeouf shows dick?
Of course, bro.
No kidding. I'm holes. No, TJ typed it. I'll go Saltburn.
Acid.
Chris Pine shows dick? Ben Affleck shows dick?
Mortal Kombat?
No. Tyler.
Scorpion.
He's just taking the Mortal Kombat category for himself.
Canada.
Where's Pine show dick?
America? United States of America? Yes.
Okay. Sonya Blade.
Oh.
Shanghai Nights or Noon.
Which one?
Nights.
Both.
Oof.
Bass.
Damn. Brandon, is this making you happy? Drink more tea.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm in it now.
Luke.
Here we go.
Johnny Cage.
Johnny Cage wins.
We got it.
Neutral.
Ooh. Shit. I think I gotta start guessing dick.
Is it Katie Ledecky?
Yeah, I think it is. I was too afraid.
That's what I was thinking.
Yes.
Yeah.
Liu Kang.
You're the only one brave enough to pull the trigger on it.
Space Kang.
Oh, yeah.
We're still all in it. Let's go, boys.
I might be out here, but I'm guessing dick. Gone Girl.
Ooh.
Nice. Hey.
Great pull.
Karate Kid.
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Come on.
I might be done.
Fuck. What could be a flavor of stuffing?
Yeah, right? Bread?
You don't think podcaster is one of the most dangerous jobs, do you?
Depends on what you say, man.
Well,
I don't know what to guess for that.
Australia.
Nice.
What is it?
Longest coastlines.
Oh. All right, Che.
Deep sea fishermen.
Oh, don't have the Mortal Kombat guys, huh?
I think I might be out.
Ooh. Yep, you're out.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that wasn't a...
Wait.
Whoa.
Honey markers. I think
all right, that works. That works. That,
yeah. All right.
Kyle?
Philippines.
I got it.
Do you know that guy?
Okay.
One eye?
Two P's, one O.
I'm racking my brain trying to think of Richard Gere.
He's not.
Oh, wow.
TJ, show me. Did we lose it? No. Show me original.
Original stuffing.
Damn. Wow. That was a good guess, though.
All right. Let's go with Raiden. R-A-I-D-E-N. Yes.
Show me
R-A-Y?
Underwater welder.
Who's this guy?
That was Raiden.
Come on.
The guy.
What about China?
Oh, yeah. No.
Oh, oh shit.
Fuck. Getting rid of the, is everybody out? But
no, Chase.
It's us too.
I'm still in.
Okay.
But if,
okay.
You guys are, if you guys don't hit on this round.
Okay. Okay.
You got
okay.
Mortal Kombat? Or you got Dick?
Countries with the longest coastlines.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I was an idiot.
That's dangerous jobs.
That's got to be...
I have other guesses.
Oh. Yeah, Russia, duh.
Yeah, that's...
Russia. Let's go.
Got to be.
Why the fuck did I not say Russia?
Yeah, I know.
Wow, yeah.
I still think Philippines might be one.
My turn?
Yeah.
South Africa?
No.
Is that a bad guess? I'm
out. Yeah.
No, that was bad. That was bad.
Bad guess.
Chile.
Wow, Brent.
Fuck.
Where do you see? Oh, you know where you saw Mark Wahlberg's dick?
Oh, come on.
Oh.
Come on.
Ted?
Who's left?
Me and him.
I've not seen that dick. I've never seen that dick.
Why?
I'm nervous for you.
Greenland is Denmark. Denmark.
What a guess. Damn.
Boogie Nights.
Oh, but that was a stunt cock.
Knights.
Just, okay.
Knights is in.
Yep. Brandon!
Yes, he
went to Denmark.
He's back.
Or do Greenland.
Ice road truck.
I think you're right, Mark.
Stovetop.
Denmark should work.
We're so stupid. It's like chicken.
What's
turkey.
The answer?
How is underwater welding? That's
chicken, turkey, all that shit.
Indonesia.
Logging.
Logging. Fuck.
Yeah.
Rap
beef,
cameraman.
Cranberry, savory herbs.
I need to see the
American chicken.
It was cop ones.
Kano.
Kano was that guy with the one laser eye. That's what he does.
Okay, and Raiden had the hat.
Raiden's the Asian guy.
Yeah.
Indonesia.
Indonesia.
Kano sucked.
Yeah, Kano sucked.
Loggers, roofers.
No, nobody.
Pilots.
He throws the.
Yeah.
What? I thought pilot was a safe job.
Nah, not the bushwhackers.
Oh.
All right.
There you go, Brandon. You're back.
What's up?
We did that for you, man. We love you.
Yeah, that was huge, Brandon.
Yeah.
Happy to cater to you, brother.
Let you win.
Yeah, we had to play a whole game so that you could do a show.
Why the hell are you doing a show?
Woo!
Got some turtle cake?
Now what do y'all want? I already had some while y'all were reading ads.
Good breakfast.
Who's
really
the
good.
Last ad?
Let's talk about our last ad. High Noon, the High Noon El Prez Pack is here featuring the top four High Noon vodka seltzer flavors ranked by Dave himself. The flavors include passion fruit, pineapple, pear is my favorite, tangerine, also very good. All made with real vodka and real juice. This 12 pack is here for only a limited time, so get it while you can. Just look for the pack with Dave's face on it. You can even scan the QR code on the pack and have El Prez virtually join your party. That's sick. Visit highnoonspirits.com to find the El Prez pack nearest you.
Do you guys want to try another parlay tonight, or we suck?
How close were we?
Not close at all.
Not close at all, I don't think.
Who hit?
Kyle's won outright, Rhode Island.
They won by like 22.
I know me and Brandon lost.
Somebody, you have North Carolina? What do you have?
No, I had Pacific plus 21 and a half. They lost by 41, I think. It was pretty close. No, I strategically picked the last game of the parlays in hopes that no one would remember.
Yeah.
My plan was the parlay's going to bust before we get to my game, so no one's going to be mad at me.
The problem is, if it's perfect to your game, you're the
I know.
Ultimate.
Did New Mexico beat
Wyoming?
I knew
that wasn't going to happen.
New Mexico did beat Wyoming.
Who do we like today? I like Georgetown plus 12 and a half.
Are we doing it?
Seton Hall. I also like High Point 20 and 4 against, they're only minus 2 and a half.
I like Stetson.
The hat?
Stetson minus 3.5.
Bennett?
They're against Bellarmine.
You like them? Why do you like them? What do you like about Stetson?
Short favorite against a really terrible team, and the line is moving towards Stetson.
I like the USC Cal over.
Give me Indiana State outright over Valpo.
Are you writing this down, TJ?
Yeah.
Syracuse.
I don't know if I have time to get it in, so someone might have to do it for me.
Syracuse with the 8.5.
I said Georgetown plus 12.5.
I'm
going to
take Xavier minus 3.
Someone should take High Point. They're 20-4, only minus 2.5.
Jay, take High Point.
Does it have to be college basketball?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
None of your nerd shit.
Jay, come on, Jay.
I'm gonna do Xavier money line. Is there like minus 3? I don't want that to ruin the parlay.
Yeah, I mean Indiana.
If we hit it, we'll get a private plane home.
Indiana State's minus 3,600.
Did anybody take Murray State? It's Murray State plus 2.5.
TJ, I might have you put this in for me because I got to go to Margaritaville. By the way, we're going to be live in Margaritaville 3-5 today.
What's that venue looking like?
I think it's like Jimmy Buffett's house.
Whoa.
Yeah. It's Margaritaville.
Haunted.
Haunted.
He recently passed, right?
He did die. Mm-hmm. Yes, Jay.
What time of day?
Murray State plus 2.5.
So if it's haunted but he just died, it's like it's a friendly ghost at this point.
Why? You think new ghosts are friendly?
I think so.
No, I think they're still pissed.
They're kind of shy how they die.
Don't you think they're shy, though? They just don't learn how to be a ghost.
How they die.
Yeah,
if
right.
They were wronged.
But he died peacefully, didn't he?
I don't know. Why does he need to get a haircut?
I'm getting angles like this.
This is wild.
What is this? Oh.
It's like a little Ashley Schaefer BMW.
Oh, yeah.
What is this?
I thought it was going to be a special.
I did, too. That's why I was confused.
Y'all told me that.
The dozen announced the celeb guests for tomorrow already.
Really?
I thought there were surprises.
Mine's not.
Oh, they're announced? Our graphic is made.
Yeah, they just tweeted out yours.
They just, all this hard work, and they just tweeted it out.
I don't know who ours is.
Honorary Frank at Gary V will be with us.
Did they do ours?
I don't know.
Maybe they just did yours because it's locked in.
Hmm?
Maybe they just did yours because it's locked in.
Okay.
Ours, we have the potential to have the best one, but it might not happen.
I told Jeff I would fly out Pokey Reese myself, but he's busy.
What's he doing?
Jeff's busy or Pokey Reese is busy?
Jeff and Pokey.
What the hell is Pokey doing?
Tell about Austin Powers.
Oh, yeah, we did want to get an Austin Powers impersonator in Vegas. He won best fat Austin Powers impersonator, and he was $7,000. But I just wanted him to be the final answer guy and say, yeah, baby. But instead, we got Gary V. Billionaire Gary V.
We tried to get
I'm
Jeremy
pumped about
James.
Gary V.
Is he definitely a billionaire?
I don't know.
Well, he's 100% not a
billionaire. Yeah, I was going to say.
He's one of those guys who said he wants
don't talk
to buy the
about
Jets,
my teammate like
and everyone
that.
Was like, oh, shit, he should buy the Jets. I don't think he's even close to buying the Jets.
Well, he needs to steal this coffee table and
I think
sell
he
it.
And Dave are the exact same level away from buying the Jets.
Yeah.
Not saying he's
poor, not broke.
He's billionaire energy without being a billionaire. Smart by him.
Let's see what his...
Can you just say you're a billionaire?
160?
That's what Google says.
Yeah, that's not even close.
But you guys were telling me he was a billionaire. Shocked, someone was.
Like, anyone could say, I want to buy a professional sports team.
I thought he had, like, multiple billion
dollars. He gives that energy off.
160? Che, you
got to clown him.
Yeah, we do got to clown him.
In your Roth IRA.
Max deposit guy.
In your money market.
I did interview him once, and I asked him, one of my questions was, how much money you got in your pocket? And he had like $1,000, and I was like, can I have it? And he just gave it to me.
What?
That was cool. That was like in like 2017.
How much money you got in your pocket?
Fuck.
It was at the Super Bowl.
Can I have it?
Oh, you know what?
What?
Oh, fuck no.
You have money?
Yeah, I do. I thought I had only $5. It's the parlay money.
It's the parlay money. Don't fuck this up for us, Brandon. We're going to get a private jet back to New York.
Oh. So,
I don't know. You said what you said. You said what you said.
Yeah.
So we'll go to New York first, drop me off, and then we'll go drop you guys off.
Yeah.
You'll come?
No. We go to New York first. You guys will come with me, and then we'll drop you guys off.
It's on the way. New York's on the way.
Yeah.
Here in Chicago.
Well, getting a private jet would be funny because we all have women out here.
Yeah, you're gonna have to. They're gonna have to fly.
Brandon, why are you shaking, man?
They're gonna have to fly commercial.
Turn your head. Turn your head. You're shaking hard. Turn your head to the left.
No, he is jittery.
His hair was quivering.
Yeah.
Your hair is wild.
I think it's because the sun
came out.
Your
hair is wild.
Wild, dude. It's wild. From the back. Wait, like,
how long's your bangs? Push your bangs down.
Shit coming out of here?
It's a small animal on your head.
Oh, this is awesome.
Yeah, that's what I like.
Oh, I chomp.
Yeah. Dude, that's right. That is right. Please.
Haven't you people ever heard of?
Please, can we do a bowl cut?
Oh, my God.
What if we did a wheel, $1,000?
Oh, my God. Oh, you look like a pilgrim.
What? You look like
Simple Jack.
Simple Jack.
Tropic Thunder?
No, the guy from the bowling movie.
Oh,
Munson.
Yeah.
Roy Munson.
No, his King friend. Glenn.
Oh my God, dude.
Yes.
The
yeah, I know who you're talking about. Fuck.
Oh.
Jeff Nadeau's hood.
What do y'all think?
Hey, can we do a wheel? 50-50, $1,000 to you, bowl haircut?
Ooh.
Or $1,000 and bowl haircut, or no $1,000, no bowl haircut?
I can't. I've worked so hard with my hair.
You haven't, though, right now.
Yeah, well, once I get it cut, it'll look better.
Yeah, once you get a bowl cut, you could also push it backwards.
Mm-hmm. Why me?
You can say no.
I don't
say
no,
why me?
No.
2000?
See?
No.
Why, Brandon?
No.
Why?
No.
What about a new boat?
Why?
I don't need a new boat. I got a great
boat.
Yeah,
you do.
No,
I got
great.
A great boat. Titus, set the record straight about my boat.
Did we comfortably
go around that lake and fish?
We did, the two of us, and not 1 pound more than us.
That's fine.
It's weird it was the guy who owned the house before.
It's a small lake.
I've never owned another man's boat, ever.
Well, I own his house, why can't I own his boat?
I would never own another man's house.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's a total cuck move to own another man's house.
Hey, it was his throwaway boat. It was a bonus boat.
Hey, I don't want this.
No, I bought the boat extra on top of the house.
How much? I'm concerned about your jitters, man.
I don't have jitters.
You do.
Hold your hand straight like that. Hold it out. Do the test.
What's the number?
Hold it out.
What's the number? Let's not play this game. What's the number that we could do a bowl haircut wheel at?
$5,000.
What's the number? I don't want to do that.
No, all right, but there's got to be a number, and I can just say no.
Why don't you go shoot for the stars, Brandon? $20,000?
$20,000.
$20,000.
$20,000, I would absolutely do it.
$10,000.
Yes, he would.
Yeah, you would have to.
Dude, you have to do grand, 10 grand.
You have to do, 10 grand.
Have to do 5 grand. A half and half
five,
wheel.
5 grand, no. 10 grand, I would do.
6?
10 grand, I would do.
6, you wouldn't?
7 I'd grand.
Do 2. 6. Do 2 grand.
10. 10. 10. 10. 10. 10. 10. Damn it, I'm at 10. I'm at 10.
6?
10.
Jitter brain.
You don't want 6 grand cash.
Imagine what you could do in Vegas with 6 grand cash.
TJ, look up boat prices.
First,
I don't need a boat.
6 grand cash?
Everyone's flying back first class and
6,500.
Who's doing the bowl cut?
We'll do it live on the air.
We'll get a bowl.
Yeah, we'll do it live on the yak. We'll have a stylist come.
$4,500 plus an unlimited bathroom pass.
Whoa. Oh, what about your own bathroom at the office?
That's your own stall. No, because I get there so early that I'm.
I would do that.
But like nobody else could use
stall.
It. You have your own stall. Stall nobody else. No can use
name nobody on. At the office would respect that.
No, it would have a lock. It'd
Nikki
key.
Smokes would
you
use
have
my shit.
Lock and a key.
Lock and key.
Lock and a key.
Lock and a key.
And you could trick it out.
Own bathroom plus
you
$2,000.
Roll out carpet. You could have your own TP.
And maybe iPads in there or something like that.
We put a shelf.
We could put tea trinkets, bobbleheads, fat heads,
dolls.
Off who?
What?
I gotta ask permission.
Off your woman?
Yeah.
Can I get a bowl cut?
For $2,000.
Let me ask her.
For your own bathroom.
How is this being executed? It's
a 50-50 wheel.
Right.
So he either gets a bowl cut, but he doesn't get any money, or he gets the money, no bowl.
He gets the money, okay.
So there's a 50% chance you just get the money.
Yeah, and nothing happens to you.
Correct.
You're financing $6,000?
Are you at 6?
No. Whatever the number was.
Is that 2 in a bathroom?
You're just going to give me $6,000?
Well, not if it hits on bowl cut.
Yeah, huh?
I'll throw in Shin Lim tickets.
I'm also leaving Friday.
Or it's a wheel.
It's a wheel. It's 50-50. So if it lands on bowl cut, I don't have to give you any money.
All right. Well, we got a...
$6,000.
Oh, y'all can't see everything.
$6,000 or 2 in bathroom and parking spot.
I got a parking spot.
With sign.
Yeah. I have a sign. I just haven't put it up.
Why don't we put all these on a wheel? and it's like two slices of bowl cut.
Why is it me? Why can't everybody else join
no
in this?
No one else needs a bowl cut.
Nobody else needs a bowl cut. All of us have
I get a bowl
pretty short hair.
Yeah.
Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Rome?
Rome! Get him in the mix.
Get him in the mix. All right. I ain't scared.
Titus?
Whoa!
I don't think I can get a bowl cut. I'm not the only one here.
I don't think I have enough hair. Nick?
Nick could definitely get...
So maybe we should just do a no money four-way bowl cut wheel.
Well, then...
I want my own bathroom.
Sounds like a great deal.
I love that. I want the bathroom.
I want a bathroom here, in the Chicago office, even though...
Yeah.
I'll part it in the middle. There, let's
go. Oh, God.
Middle part? Okay, well, we have two more shows this week, so
yeah, we'll figure it out. Well,
okay, we'll do it.
Let me talk to management, and we'll.
I will.
See.
Join.
I also it also is dependent on how I do gambling today. I'm just being honest. Like the $6,000 offer may not be here tomorrow.
Okay,
but it also could go up.
But yeah, Jeff Lowe might be able to find.
Dude, fuck
it.
The money. Let's just we have to commit all of us.
Bowl cut?
How are you going to bowl cut?
Let's do a punishment wheel. One person has to get a. What's the equivalent of a bowl cut that I could get?
Bald.
Nah, I'm doing that.
Mohawk.
Tattoo.
No gym for 3 months.
Ooh.
All right. Yeah, no.
Yeah.
I could get Everyone something. I would get a crazy piercing, not a tattoo.
Nose ring.
Oh. Yes.
I'd get a tattoo.
Okay.
Want to get a crazy piercing?
Well,
he does. Yeah, I do.
Tattoo's permanent. Bowl cuts for a month.
The images are forever.
What would Che have to do? You can't eat pussy.
Bowl cut on him would be problematic.
He has to be wet for 3 months.
I've had a bowl cut.
Yeah, right. Mm.
What would Che have to do? No glasses.
A wok cut.
I can go no glasses.
No glasses, no contacts.
Oh, that's
just making people laugh.
And you have to drive. You have to drive everywhere.
You have to drive everywhere. You have to bring your kids to to work every day.
Big diamond studs.
Oh, hoop.
Oh, that would look way too good.
Two hoops?
Or the dangly cross.
Two
hoops. Yeah, dangly Che cross. With the cross and dangly cross.
I would do one in the left.
Sure, of course, man.
Because you're not
okay,
gay.
That would rock.
Yeah, dangly cross.
All right, so are we going to do it?
Yeah. And I kind of want to do it right now.
I do, too.
Hey, I might have to get a bowl cut.
Titus?
What's the cash? Well, what's the cash situation?
How was this?
What if
I think the cash is out.
Yeah, I think we should just have to do this.
I think just one person has to do
this. We did this in LA.
And you only have to keep the bowl haircut for what? A week?
A week.
Probably a week or 2 weeks.
It should be $1,000 cat. I think it should be a name wheel.
Yeah,
and
okay.
Whoever it lands
on,
then it's like the cash or the thing.
Yes.
I can't. I'm not allowed.
Brandon, it won't land on you.
I'm not allowed.
It won't land on you.
You're not allowed?
No, I'm not allowed.
You drive your wife everywhere since 07. You're not allowed?
I'm just saying.
Just stop driving her. Yeah. Like, you don't get...
All right, you're stuck at the house.
I like what Rome was saying, that you get... If you lands on you, you automatically get $1,000.
Deal.
Mm-hmm. Brand.
What do you want me to say?
So if you're the one that has to get the bowl cut, you still get $1,000.
What do you mean? What do you want me to...
Yes.
Oh, shit. Driver crazy, shit. Well, at least you're driving.
Everybody's thing is.
All right, let's just do a practice run. This doesn't count.
Okay, practice
let's just
run.
Let's see what would have happened.
Because some people don't even
first
have
name
bad
up
things.
Would have had to get it.
Okay.
First name that it lands on would have had to get it.
Well, I want something bad.
It's a practice run.
Okay.
Can your ears pierce?
Yes.
Okay. That's a good question.
Loves. Kind of a diss.
Well, I mean, crazy piercings. Well, reasonable question.
So whoever it landed on
would have had.
TJ, you'd have to get fat again.
Yeah. TJ, think how fun that would be.
TJ,
how
that
fun would that be, dude?
That would be a blast for
that turtle. 80 pounds back on in like 3 weeks.
Dude, that'd be a blast
so
for a little bit.
Oh, man. He's so mean. All right, so whoever it lands on would have had to do it. This is a practice run.
This is just practice.
Practice run.
But I don't want it to land on me here.
Yeah, no, I know.
Oh, damn.
Oh, Roan, you survived those practice right. runs.
If I will sign on, can I do bowl cut? But I want to keep a long rat tail.
Yes, really I sign off on that.
Thank you. Thank you, boss. Thank you. Thank you, boss.
I got wet as hell yesterday on that wheel. We want to spin a regular wheel?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it.
Brandon, you could also just come in with a haircut tomorrow and completely remove yourself from this.
No, because we'd have to think of something else.
The wheel was so just.
You can't do something you want.
Yeah, no.
I guess I kind of do want to do, but I don't.
What about nipple piercing? One nipple.
Yeah, I'd do that.
Would you do it?
No, well, yeah, I would do it. I wouldn't want it.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
You said you want a tattoo for a while.
I know, but how long can you say you want a tattoo with kind of being like you don't?
You don't.
Because like if I wanted one, I would have had
it. Maybe we can pick it.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, that would I would do that.
Okay.
I would do that.
Do you get like a Cody Parkey jersey?
Oh, man. That would be mean. All right, we'll think of something. Your bowl cut's really out, Brandon? What about rat tail?
I'll work on it this afternoon. I'll probably be able to do the bowl cut when I come in tomorrow.
There's a.
You're gonna have to really lay it down tonight.
It's a 1 in 8 chance.
She has a very nice.
You don't get it.
And
or
no, it's
7 in 8 chance.
No. Yeah.
That you don't get it. Titus has been very quiet.
I'm thinking. I'm doing a lot of thinking.
Titus is thinking about his whole life.
I would like the bowl cut, but. It's more the like growing. Yeah. What's the timetable?
It's like 2 weeks.
Through the timetable.
You could slick your hair back when you have a bowl cut,
or you could just like wear it messy.
I gotta grow it back
you
out.
You can't tell it's messy. No, you don't.
Growing no, it back your out. Your hair that's will such still be kind of long. It'll just be in a bowl.
To grow it out, you gotta do nothing.
Yeah, but it takes forever. I would rock a bowl cut. It's just more like, all right.
I wish I could.
We're
rock.
Done with the bowl cut.
I
what
think
do we
be
do now?
Easy.
I do need
a haircut. You are right.
Then let's do it. And then if it lands on you, that's when you have
it. All right, what about like dyeing it purple?
The rainbow.
Well, how much would that cost?
I'd rather get it cut.
$20,000 for
a rainbow? What about dyeing your beard black?
Oh, that would actually rock. Hollywood Hulk.
That would
rock. That would rock.
Would you do that for free?
You would look cool.
Not for free, but I would do it.
You'd probably do that for 50.
Yeah.
$50?
No.
Should we do Black Beard Week?
You know, for Super Bowl 2 years ago, it landed on me to bleach my beard. And
what?
I bleached it completely blonde. We had goatees at the time because we just done goatee week. I bleached it entirely blonde and nobody noticed because my beard is just white. So it didn't.
We should do goatee week again.
I would grow my beard out and dye black.
Oh, goatee week rocked. I'd do goatee week again. We looked awesome.
You look so cool. What, Kyle?
Oh.
If that isn't merch, what is that?
Yeah, what could we possibly be getting?
Is there? Oh,
Canes
there is
merch.
Okay. I know we have boxes here for an activity we're doing tomorrow.
I got nothing from you, bud.
We have boxes
Say it again?
Here for an activity we're doing.
We have Ooh. Boxes here for an activity we're doing tomorrow.
Oh, I know nice. That activity. It's going to be very fun.
Yes.
Very fun. You know it?
I know what it is. I don't know what items are.
Okay, I'll just say what we're going to do. I won't say what it is. We have a sponsor, memorabilia. So we have 8 pieces of memorabilia that we'll get to draft. And there's some good stuff in there.
We get to keep memorabilia?
Yes.
What?
Yes. There's some really good stuff. And there's also stuff specifically that like someone would really want. Another
person.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
Love that.
We do a wheel for a swap at the end? Okay.
Good.
Fuck yes.
Yeah.
Maybe a little I want that.
Yeah.
I want that.
Let me see the TJ, did you send me the final list?
Che, would you bleach your hair blonde?
Oh.
God, you look awesome.
You look really cool.
You look like Juntao.
Cool.
Yeah,
from
I think
Rush
you would.
Yeah, that's exactly who you look. No, it wasn't.
Mr. Juntao!
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Shit. There are some awesome. Can I say a couple of them?
Say one.
Say one.
Brandon, can I get a
say two.
Turtle cake?
Okay, I'll say two.
Hand me a clump of that cake.
Hand him the clump.
There's a Taylor Swift
and
one.
What? Like signed?
And there's a boxing glove signed by Mike Tyson.
Whoa.
Wow.
God.
Yeah. There's some good stuff. One of your favorites, one of Roan's favorite Sixers of all time, maybe?
Ooh.
Signed something.
LaVoy Allen.
Eric Snow? All right. Good yak, boys.
Did it land on dry? Did we
great
do that?
Yak. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
It's been hot. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. Tomorrow, we're going to do that draft and memorabilia, and we might have a punishment wheel. Mm-hmm. So thank you, everyone. Please subscribe. See everyone tomorrow. Also, tune in Margaritaville 3 to 5 today on the all the Barstool Sports main channels.
6 Eastern.
6 Eastern, 3 to 5 Pacific. See ya.
Come on out to Margaritaville. Watch the stream. Love you guys. Bye.